Meadowlands Arena in East Rutherford, New Jersey. It's Chicago Sting Indoor Soccer. Tonight, the Sting take on the New York Cosmos in their first meeting since the Sting won the 1981 Soccer Bowl. The Cosmos are hungry for revenge in this rematch, but the Sting has a history of success against New York with 7 wins in their last 8 meetings. Chicago Sting Soccer is brought to you in part by your Chicagoland Porsche Audi dealers.
On defense, number 2.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Howard Balser, along with Kenny Stern, welcoming you to high-speed, action-packed indoor soccer. Tonight, your Soccer Bowl champions, the Chicago Sting, take on the New York Cosmos. Chicago, fresh off the heels of a heart-stopping 9-8 victory over Tulsa in the season opener last Saturday night. The Cosmos have yet to play a regular season indoor game, but they did defeat the Montreal Matic in an exhibition game. Tonight is the first of several Chicago Sting indoor soccer games that are going to be brought to you on Channel 32. And with the 2 premier scorers in all of soccer out here, Karl-Heinz Granita, who led indoor last year, all the scorers in indoor, and has been twice now the runner-up to the great Giorgio Chinaglia of the Cosmos. Kenny, we have a tremendous matchup for our first Channel 32 indoor game.
We certainly do. Of course, Giorgio Chinaglia has rewritten all the outdoor records, and Giorgio says he's going to rewrite the indoor records.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be back with back again at Burn Arena, a brand new arena in the Meadowlands, East Rutherford, New Jersey. The singer doing the rendition of America the Beautiful and our national anthem was Benny King. And Kenny, while the teams are getting set, let's continue with that analysis of the game tonight between Chicago and New York.
Well, of course, you have the two premier teams in the North American Soccer League. 10 weeks ago, they fought it out in the Soccer Bowl for the championship. Chicago came out on top with that 1-0 shootout victory. The Cosmos would like to avenge that defeat today, as well as 6 other defeats. Chicago holds a 7-1 career lifetime record against the Cosmos outside. Of course, inside, it's a different story.
They'll be playing 4 15-minute quarters. The Sting starting out with Karl-Heinz Granita, Tasso Katsoukas, Ingo Peter, Brett Hall, Charlie Fikas, and in the goal, Jimmy Brown. The Cosmos going with Giorgio Chinaglia, Steve Wagerly, Nelsie Moraes, Carlos Alberto, and Adranik Eskandarian with young American David Bursich in the goal. The referee will be Dave Socha, and the reserve referee, Felix Fuchsman.
Howard, the Cosmos, of course, have never played indoor soccer in the North American Soccer League, so it'll be interesting to see how long it takes the Cosmos to adjust to the indoor game. Of course, there is a period of adjustment that's necessary to play indoors. Chicago found it out. It took them a game and a half when they began last year. The Cosmos hope they can adjust quickly. Incidentally, Pat Leahy, the kicker of the New York Jets, as well as Joe Dinello, the kicker of the New York Giants, 2 ex-All-American soccer players in college, will be kicking out the opening balls tonight.
In the first quarter, the Chicago Sting will move from your right to your left. They are wearing their black uniforms, yellow numerals and trim, yellow hose, the Cosmos all in white, with blue and green numerals and trim. Chicago had a real squeaker. 9-8 win over Tulsa, where Chicago had a 9-5 lead with just about 3.5 minutes to go, and the Roughnecks came right back, and Chicago almost suffered defeat from the jaws of victory, but a great save by Jimmy Brown in the final seconds. We held on, and now we take a one-game lead over Tulsa in that division of ours. The Cosmos, while Kenny is correct, they have not played a regular season game, did go up to Montreal and defeat Montreal in an exhibition game by a score of 8-7. And they had an exhibition, Kenny, I guess a scrimmage against one of the local minor league teams, and Chinaglia, I think, got 8 goals in just a matter of minutes. The field itself, 200 feet long, it's 85 feet wide, and Kenny, that'll give this thing a lot more running room than they had in Tulsa.
It certainly will. Of course, Chicago's field is 190 feet long, and in Tulsa it was 185 feet long, they said, but it was really no longer than 165 feet. There's a good look at the Chicago bench there, Rudy Glenn and Pato Marhedic filling up
boys.
a little bit on the Gatorade before the game.
Right in the picture, Greg Ryan is there, and there's Peter Ferner and Jerry Carter. Burn Arena, brand new, holds 19,000 fans. They're expecting a crowd of between 13 and 15,000 tonight. It's a rainy night. And we are getting set to go. Karl-Heinz Granita along with Charlie Fikas. Granita, the number one scorer in all of indoor soccer last year. Fikas, the leading American in indoor scoring. Number 6 in the league overall. Chicago has plenty of potential and plenty of punch. Their Americans rank probably higher than any group of Americans in the North American Soccer League, outdoor or indoor.
Certainly so. Howard, right before the game, when Carlos Alberto was announced, he got a standing ovation here. Carlos, of course, played for the Cosmos for a few seasons outdoors, was a fan's favorite player here, and then he was eventually let go and picked up by California, where he spent a season. Now he has returned to the New York metropolitan area to play indoors for the Cosmos, and it was really quite an emotional scene as the fans all stood up and cheered when his name was announced.
Number 12 on the Cosmo bench you're looking at right now is Stevie Moyers. Very, very fine American scorer. Came to the Cosmos in a dispersal draft after the California Ball Club pulled in its tent. And another returnee to the Cosmo lineup is Nelson Moraes, a Brazilian international who played in two or three soccer bowls for the Cosmos before retiring, but they brought him back for indoor.
Yes, they certainly did. Of course, some of these players, Alberto, of course, 37, they say, going on about 45. Nobody really knows how old he is. Steve Moyers and Steve Weggerly of the Cosmos have had indoor experience, and they were both excellent players. Steve Weggerly with Tampa Bay last season scored 25 goals, he had 20 assists, while Moyers had 19 goals and 17 assists with the California club.
If you haven't seen indoor soccer, you're in for a treat as the Sting kicks off. Ingle Peter across the center stripe. The field is divided into three sections. Ingle Peter now, top of the slot. His first shot is rejected by Carlos Alberto Brett Hall. Sting side of the midfield stripe. Puts it down in the Cosmo zone. Alberto just lays it along the boards. They'll use those boards as if they were another player. Long pass upfield, kicked away by Hall. Taken back by Ficus. To Tasso Katsoukas. Tasso got three goals, the hat trick, in that first game. Chicago battled off the ball by Nelson Moraes and by Eskandarian, and here comes Steve Wagley. Now Moraes in the Sting attack zone. Katsoukas on him. Near side, Giorgio Chinaglia. Tries to go back to Eskandarian. Ficus covering up, now to Chinaglia. Gets around Ficus. Gets the boards, kicked away by Hall. Up to Granitza. Eskandarian on him, lays it back for Ficus. Sting moving, right to left. We've just started play here in the Meadowlands. Chicago against New York. Katsoukas shot rejected, and returned by Granitza. Another shot by Katsoukas. Coming back to Alberto, upfield to Chinaglia. First real scoring threat of the game, Chicago.
Excellent save on the part of Brisic there as Granitza fired from point blank, and Brisic, the goalkeeper for the Cosmos, smothered the shot.
And now Carlos Alberto back to the goalkeeper. As we were saying, the field is divided into thirds. The attack zones are marked by red lines, very similar to hockey's blue lines, while the center stripe divides the midfield. There are no offsides called about a man being in position. You can keep a sleeper down there all day long, but a ball cannot travel over both red lines without touching someone. There's a long pass headed away by Brown. Once Jimmy Brown, the goalkeeper, comes out of the penalty area, he can no longer use his hands. He must use his feet or head like any other field player. Moraes is going to get whistled for a foul, putting a knee into Ingo Peter, and we have the first foul of the game. Direct free kick for Chicago as Steve Moyers comes on. Also coming on, Ferdinando de Matthaeis.
Derek Spalding for Chicago entered the field.
To Granitza. Carlos Alberto marking him. Against the glass, trying to go for Ficus. Return in front. Ficus. Granitza. Off the ball, Eskandarian. Now Spalding. Steve Moyers and Spalding colliding. Moyers coming out with the ball. Hall smothers it. Comes back to Nelson Moraes. Back to Carlos Alberto. Canalia is out. Now Di Matthaeis. Off he goes once again to Moraes, picked up by Hall. To Matthaeis, kind of a roving striker. Gets it back against the glass, stopped by Brown. Ingo Peter moves along the boards on the far side. Clock shows we have played 2.5 minutes in this first period. No score. Derek Spalding leaves it for Pato Marhedic, the magic man, on the floor for the first time. He's got room to go. Tripped up, tries to keep his balance. Down goes Moraes, and now Granitza comes back quickly to give it to Peter, back to Granitza. Looking for Marhedic, get the inner boards. Back to Ingo Peter, just inside the red line, to Granitza, trying to turn, can't do it. Cosmos trying to clear. Marhedic there, doing some of his dribbling magic. Ball taken away by the experienced Nelson Moraes. Hall colliding with Moyers in the center stripe. We're gonna have a foul on Brett Hall.
If you fans back home are having a little problems, it's not your television set. We're having a little bit of a breakup here, so keep your set tuned in. It'll be taken care of shortly.
Getting a tripping call now on Greg Ryan into the ball game for the first time. Ryan got two goals and assist in the Sting's opening victory. Steve Moyers, away by Hall. And we're going to have a foul on Moyers, elbowing on Brett Hall. The Sting will now have the ball. And a reminder, Kenny, that we're going to have our home opener this a week from this coming Friday evening, 7:30 at the Chicago Stadium. We're taking on Gordie Hill and the Montreal Manic. It's going to be Budweiser night. The first 10,000 fans are going to receive a nice little memento from Budweiser as Jimmy Brown flings it to Karl-Heinz Grenitza. He's been on the floor the whole time. Tomar Hedick. He's got Spalding on the far side. To Grenitza again. A shot. Oh, just smothered by Burchett as Grenitza tried to go to the near post.
Yes, actually, Brissick pinned the ball against the side post right there. They have goal judges down there, so the ball did not go all the way over the line. Brissick very fortunate there that ball got smothered. He very easily could have knocked it back into his own net.
Give and go with Spalding, trying to break through. Should get an obstruction call at least. No, the foul's going to go against Chicago.
No, that's going to go against the Cosmos. It's going to be a two-minute penalty as well because Spalding had an excellent chance to score, so we will see the Chicago power play.
Derek limping as he gets up, holding in his right ankle. Chicago now with a power play situation. Cosmos are sending to the bench Earhart Kapp, young rookie that they're taking a look at for the first time.
Chicago's power play in Tulsa looked very, very inept. Chicago's coach Willie Roy very concerned about it, and he talked quite a bit about it today during their pregame meal. He wants a lot more activity out of Podomer Hedick in the middle with Mark Symington trying to create problems for the goalkeeper.
That close-up you had was of Earhart Kapp, came from the University of Missouri at St. Louis. Now we have Mar Hedick, Charlie Ficus, Ingo Peter, Mark Symington, and Karl-Heinz Grenitza on the power play.
The Chicago Sting's next game on television will be Wednesday, December 23rd at 8 o'clock p.m. as the Sting play the Tampa Bay Rowdies here on WFLD TV, Channel 32.
And the Rowdies are loaded. They're tied with the Sting for the division lead in the Central Division. The Rowdies won their first game. Coming back, they were trailing 4-1 to Montreal, came back and beat them 8-5. Grenitza, oh man, that ball skies up into the seats, but it was deflected, I believe, by a Cosmo or not. Will we have a goal kick?
It'll be a goal kick for the Cosmos. However, we should explain, for indoor soccer, the referee does have the discretion whether or not to just give a free kick or send a player away for 2 minutes. His thinking there is he sent the Cosmos player Kapp off the field was that Kapp intentionally fouled Derek Spalding, and Spalding broke through, and so he sent him off for 2 minutes.
Once again, you saw Jimmy Brown coming out of the penalty area, having to use his feet. Can't use his hands. Now Ingo Peter in the attack zone. Right up the slot, the shot, stopped in front, and tried to clear out of there was Iarushi. Well, remember Iarushi, his was the last shot that Dieter Ferner saved for the Sting to win the soccer bowl. And now Ficus, as the power play tries to form up. A minute and a half to go in the power play. Mar Hedick, oh, he zigged. Tried to go to Symington. Symington had taken his position right out in front of the goal. Pato gets it back. Pato moving in, tries to go to Grenitza, gets him. Back to Wingo. To Ficus, moving in from the far point, back to Wingo. Sting trying to set it up. Grenitza, a little bit of room against the glass. Header, Symington, return Mar Hedick. The Magic Man has given Chicago the 1-0 lead, the first power play goal for Chicago of the 1981-82 season.
Yes, Grenitza and Symington should get assist right there. Grenitza played the ball off the boards. He was not shooting. It came high off the glass. Mark Symington, doing his job, cut right in front of the goalkeeper, headed the ball. It hit the glass again, and Pato Marhedic had an easy time from out front.
That's Pato's first goal of the year. Picked up a couple of assists against Tulsa. Now Cosmos kicking off Steve Wagley. Hooked up by Paul Hahn. This is Paul's first appearance for the Sting. Didn't play in Tulsa. Shot off the glass. A return. Taken right back to Bandoff. Bandoff over to Wagley. Puts it back to Kapp, who, of course, is back on the floor now. The Sting scored. It's just like hockey. Man scores. The penalty is over. Long lead to little Davey Husson moving in against the glass. Return. Just misses wide. Pato almost had goal number two. Here comes Ricky Davis. Sensational young American. Upfield to Wagerly. Symington covering. Back to Davis. To Wagerly. Now back to Kapp. Picked up by Husson. His shot grabbed by Brown. He has Marhedic free. Tries to go to him. Broken up by Davis. Marhedic pushes Davis down. That's a very obvious foul. Cosmos are calling for a penalty. I don't think there'll be one.
Howard, looking at that last throw by Jimmy Brown to Marhedic, you might wonder why he didn't lob it over the player. You cannot pass the ball, not from the field or from the goal, from the goalie, over three lines. That's
right.
An offside, so he had to try and throw the ball off the glass or just throw it and hit the ground to get it to Marhedic.
Trying to go inside of Chinaglia. His shot saved by Jimmy Brown. Chinaglia volleyed that ball beautifully, and Brown went high in the air to tap it away. Corner kick for the Cosmos.
Tremendous reactions on Jimmy's part, because it was not a hard shot, but yet it was a surprising shot, and Jimmy just got that hand up in time.
Wiggly would take the corner kick. Sting out there with Hahn, Symington, Husson, Hall, and Marhedic. This is Wiggly out in front to Davis. A shot saved by Brown. Kicked away. Wiggly with it. Hahn fighting him for the ball. Back to Boris Bandoff outside the red line. Into the attack zone. To Chinaglia. Back to Davis. 1-0. Chicago leads it on a power play goal by Marhedic. Down to Matthaeis. Picked up by Hahn. Symington trying to clear it. Can't do it. Back to Davis again at the far point. To Wagerly. Husson on him. Try to go inside. Picked up by Marhedic. Here comes the Magic Man. On the run. A shot. Saved by Persich. Back to Wagerly. Up and down. Remember, the only offside is a ball over both lines. Up against the glass. Canalia shot. Misses. Header. Misses. Game of inches. Out to Rudy Glenn. On the floor for the first time. Here comes Rudy on the run, coming with Pato. Rudy, the shot, just in front. Return score. Pato Marhedic taking the deflection off of the hands of the goalkeeper on the shot by Glenn. Pato has his second goal, the Sting a 2-0 lead.
It's funny how things turn around. Pato Marhedic, the same kind of goal. The Cosmos had a tremendous chance at one end of the field. Chicago turned it back, and Rudy Glenn hustling across, got the shot away. Brissick made the save. But unfortunately for the Cosmos, fortunately for Chicago, Pato Marhedic banged in the rebound.
So the Magic Man with two goals. If Rudy Glenn gets the assist, which we expect he'll get, that'll be his first point of the season. Cosmos coming back now. Ricky Davis. Hawk shows just over 8 minutes remaining in the first period. 4 15-minute quarters. It looked like it almost an obstruction. Di Matthaeis colliding with Greg Ryan in the box. Granita past Glenn, but coming up is Ingo Peter. Now we have a 3-on-3. Ingo into the attack zone. To Granitz in front, Persich, the slide save. Flings it up front to Moyers, broken up by Brett Hall. And finally, the ball bounces into the stands. It's going to be a kick-in. There are no throw-ins in indoor soccer. It's a kick-in. But as you've already seen, there's free substitution. There are penalty boxes and penalties, much like ice hockey. Stevie Moyers, Brett Hall will run it down. Sting leading it 2-0. 7.5 minutes to go. We're telling you about the home opener on Friday evening, December 18th. You can get ticket information, 558-KICK, 558-KICK. Beautiful through ball by Peter to Ryan, to Granita. Carl is held up by Davis, no call. Carl can't believe it. And finally, Davis overruns it, but he comes back and gets it to Matthaeis coming up the near side. Di Matthaeis picked up by Glenn, to Moyers. Jimmy Brown kicks it against the glass, but Marias is there. Up front, Hall kicks it away to Granita. He's got Iskandarian to beat, but he lays it back to Ingo Peter. You can use your Visa or MasterCard when ordering Sting tickets. You can get them at the Sting office, 333 North Michigan. You can also get them at Ticketron. Or you can go see Jolly Tom at the 333 North Michigan Tobacco Shop. Remember, the home opener, the 18th, up against the glass, headed away by Iskandarian. Spalding in the track. Bangs it off the glass. Marias fighting Ingo Peter. Another rule I think we should warn the fans about, Kenny, if in the referee's decision you kick the ball out of the arena, up into the stands, out of the playing surface, that could be a 2-minute penalty for delay of the game. David Matthaeis and Spalding racing around. And ball skips by Brown, but no harm done.
Yes, Howard, but only if the referee deems that you did it intentionally. You are allowed to kick it in the crowd if it is accidentally.
Casa Katsoukas was waltzing down the near boards with Carlos Alberto. It's going to be a foul on Tassel for holding.
They're going to send him off.
Him to the prom.
They're going to send him off for 2 minutes. Evidently, the referee ruled that Tassel fouled hard near the boards. You'll see quite often a good referee will send players off for 2 minutes if the foul occurs near the boards as opposed to in the middle of the field, because it's very dangerous near those boards and a player can get hurt when he goes crashing into the boards.
Just over 6 minutes remaining in the first period. The penalty killers for Chicago. All Ryan, Pikus, Spalding. Cosmos have Carlos Alberto, Giorgio Chinaglia, Ferdinando de Matthaeis. Now let's see who else they have out there. Stevie Moyers right up front. And Steve Wagerly. There's Willie Roy with assistant coach Mike Ribbage. Willie sporting a brand new suit and tie, feeling mighty spiffy. 2-0, the Sting leads it. Two goals by the Magic Man, Pato Marhedic.
I think Pato may be turning into the bad guy, or Tasso, I should say, the bad man in the league. He had two penalties in Tulsa, and now one tonight. He's had three now for the season.
Chinaglia, Moyers, give and go. Ryan is there, pushes it back to Carlos Alberto. Now, to Moyers, his shot deflected against the glass. Spalding's going to come out with it. Remember, the Sting is shorthanded now. Derek on the run, controlling that ball, killing off precious seconds. Working with Hall, the Joy Bulldog. Just standing on the ball, and nobody is forcing him. The shot deflected. Nobody was pushing Spalding. He could have stood with that ball all night.
Greg Ryan.
Moyers. Slips and falls. Charlie Pikus is there.
Greg Ryan made an ill-advised run right there. Of course, you're killing a penalty, so you only have four players on the field, and Chicago got caught with three of them attacking.
And now Carlos Alberto, the experienced World Cup captain for Brazil. Up to the Chinaglia, shot against the glass. Return score by Carlos Alberto. The Cosmos have scored on the power play. We have a 2-1 game.
Chicago got caught with two players downfield trying to stall. The Cosmos came back 3-on-2. Giorgio hit it off the glass. It ricocheted. Carlos Alberto banged it in from short range. No chance for the goalkeeper, Jimmy Brown.
Imagine Chinaglia will get the assist. 5:14 left. So they scored in less than a minute of that power play, and now we have a 2-1 game. Husan coming on for Chicago, along with Pato Marhedic and Rudy Glenn. Tasso Katsoukas, of course, is back on the floor. Want to say hello to Charlie Ficus's mother, Betty. Never misses a Sting broadcast or telecast, and Betty said, oh, she's going to love to watch indoor soccer on Channel 32. First time we've been on regular television for indoor soccer, Kenny. Hope the fans enjoy it. Pato Marhedic. Ball kicked away by Boris Bandoff. On the run, he comes. Dady Husan coming back quickly. Outruns Bandoff. Commissioner of the North American Soccer League, Phil Woosdom, up in our booth. He'll be joining us at halftime. Don't go away. Ficus. Back to Glenn. Back to Ficus. Now to Dady Husan. To Glenn, picked up by Davis. Back to Husan. It was Alberto, assisted by Chinaglia. Ficus trying to get position, broken up. Bandoff has it. Gets it over to Daryl G, a rookie just signed by this ball club. To Stevie Moyers. Katsoukas on him. Tasso staying clear of the boards. He learned his lesson. Back to Cap. Near boards. Marhedic fighting for it. Run off the ball by Bandoff. Let's see how the call goes. Referee David Socha coming over. He's going to give the ball to Chicago.
Yes, David Socha, the referee, the assistant referee, Felix Sutzman. It happened right in front of the assistant referee, so he used his whistle. In indoor soccer, the assistant referee does have a whistle, and he can use a whistle anytime he sees a foul.
Tasso Katsoukas, Charlie Ficus, the left foot bounces off of Davis into the stands. The Stinger's going to have a kick in right from the corner. Kenny, doesn't it seem interesting that in indoor soccer, a smaller playing surface, you can have two people blowing a whistle. In outdoor soccer, with that giant field, they only allow one. Marhedic wants the corner kick, but the referee Socha is backing him up and saying, no, it's just a kick in. 2-1, the Sting leads it with just under 4 minutes to go in the first period. Marhedic out in front of that line, just misses. Good save by the goalkeeper, Versich. And now Katsoukas. Back to Davy Husan. Katsoukas getting the hat trick against Tulsa. Keeps it in the midfield. Now Husan loses control, but Katsoukas is there. Now to Glenn. Tries to go inside to Marhedic. Marhedic position. He's kind of shoved. Goalkeeper is down. Marhedic fighting for it, but Daryl G comes out with it. Broken up by Katsoukas. Good back heel pass to Marhedic. Katsoukas against the glass. Out in front. Goalkeeper Versich takes it.
That could have been an own goal there as it came off the glass and hit Ricky Davis, but the goalkeeper Versich recovered very well. Got up quick to smother any possible goal opportunity.
And Katsoukas is being held down there by Knight. The Sting will have a free kick. You know, moments earlier, I alluded to the fact that the commissioner was in the booth. Well, we don't really have a booth here. It's a beautiful arena, but when they built it, they really didn't account for television. We're right out there with the fans, so if you hear the vendors and the fans screaming, they're coming right into our mic. Up against the glass, gets by, gets up. Glenn's shot misses wide. Cap lets it go for Versich. Sting continuing to press. 2-1 lead. Less than 3 minutes to go in the first period. Chicago against New York, another classic matchup. First time they've battled each other indoors, though. In all these years, the Sting has only lost to the Cosmos one time in outdoor. And, of course, Kenny, that was an own goal that beat the Sting, remember? Back in, I think, 1977. Charlie Ficus. Working with Derek Spaulding. Mark Symington coming up on the near boards. This is Mark's 23rd birthday today. Maybe he can get himself a goal or two to celebrate. He's a fighter. Vinitsa, guy trying to get position, broken up. Steve Wagley has it now. Vinitsa looking for the referee. And now here comes Wagley. Spaulding bothering him. Wagley coming in for the shot. Up front, he scores. Wagley scores, as it appeared Jimmy Brown was screened by Ingo Peter.
Yes, Jimmy Brown was screened, as well as the presence of Chinaglia. It was actually a two-on-one situation. Wagley was trying to play the ball through to Chinaglia to tip in, and I think Jimmy Brown was a little bit concerned over three players standing in front of him, and the ball just found its way in the back of the net there. But I don't really think Wagley was even trying to shoot there.
2 minutes, 2 seconds to go in the first period. We're all tied at two. Singh had a 2-0 lead, but as you'll soon find out, if you're not familiar with indoor soccer, two-goal leads don't mean much in this game. High-scoring game. And the Sting, with 145 goals, was the highest-scoring team in indoor soccer last year. Wagley trying to go through on Hall, breaks it up. Symington fought for it, but Moraes has it again to Chinaglia. Shot against the glass. Cleared out by Hall. Chinaglia, very, very tricky, very elusive. Here comes Hall. Kicked away from him. Taken by Wagley. Symington fighting him. Wagley still has it. Tries to go to Chinaglia. Ball deflected. Moraes' header goes up into the crowd. It's going to be a kick in for Chicago's Mark Symington. Taps it up to Karl Heinz Granica. 42 goals last year, 27 assists, 111 points. Tops in the indoor. Ingo Peter looking for Granica up against the glass. Karl shot against the glass. Nobody there but Moraes to Alberto. Now we have a minute and 10 to go. Cosmos on the attack. They go to Chinaglia. Hall trying to cover. Able to get a piece of it. Giorgio through. A shot saved by Brown. The return kicked away by Spaulding. Out in front, Moraes over the glass. Return. Hitter Chinaglia. Cosmos lead. Giorgio Chinaglia in perfect position. Headed that ball past Brown. And the Cosmos, with three unanswered goals, have a 3-2 lead.
Simple breakdown of the Chicago defense there, Howard. They just could not get the ball out. The Cosmos were on transition as they turned the play back. Here you're going to have a replay. You're going to see Chicago just unable to clear the ball out. A good play by Giorgio, playing it off the boards himself. Now he takes a shot. You'll see Giorgio gets caught in front of the net, falls down, and he gets up just in time to head it in.
Kenny, isn't it often true when you have so many near misses as the Sting did? Three or four great opportunities, and you can't put it in. The other team will come back, and it haunts you every time. Boyers out in front. Ball kicked away by Brown. Good move to Ingo Peter. Grounded it on his own. Less than 30 seconds to go now in the first period. Cosmos leading 3-2. Crowd continuing to come in to Burn Arena in the middle end. Howard Balsam here with Ken Stern. Ingo Peter. He hasn't had a goal yet this year. He's due to Granica. And we're going to have a foul called right at the corner of the box against Escandarian for grabbing Karl Heinz Granica. 10 seconds left on the clock.
Yes, 10 seconds left in the first period. Chicago's been unable to work the ball into Granica. What the Cosmos have done is they've laid a player from the front line back to kind of front Karl Heinz there, and it's Chicago's had a hard time getting the ball to him.
Direct free kick for Karl Heinz. The shot is rejected, and Bursic grabs it. And now with 5 seconds left in the period, he flings it upfield to DeMatteis. Ryan on him. Ryan is pushed down. Battle for the ball. Greg comes up with it, but there is the horn ending the first period of play. With the score, the Chicago Sting 3-2. And Ryan is being whistled for a 2-minute penalty. His collision with DeMatteis right after the horn had sounded. Willie Roy coming on. He wants to protest it, but when we start the second period, Greg Ryan is going to have a couple minutes in the penalty box, and we'll be back with the wrap-up on the first period action. Cosmos leading 3-2 after these messages. A reminder that on Friday the 18th, when the Sting hosts the Montreal Manic at the stadium, the Sting will be honoring the residents of Northbrook and Palatine. Youth teams from these towns will participate in a pregame, and discounts are available for residents at the Northbrook Park District Sports Center and the Palatine Park District. There is Willie Roy, and he is plenty burned up. In that game also, Roy was not only kicked out, Ingo Peter was kicked out in that outdoor game when we won that game shorthanded.
Howard, I wonder whether Willie Roy really wants Dieter Ferner serving the second penalty, because when the first player comes out, Chicago will... What's going to happen is both players will come out at the same time. Dieter will have to run over to the bench, and Chicago will have to substitute there. Instead, Willie might rather place a field player in the box who could come off and then be in the field plate.
Second period has started. Make a good point there, Kenny. Cosmos have five field players to three for the Sting. Hall, Ficus, Spalding, the penalty killers. Here's Chinaglia. Cosmos lead at 3-2. Wagerly, the glass kicked away by Jimmy Brown. Now, here's a case, Kenny, with two men down, Brown can kick at the length of the floor without an offside being called.
That's right. One man down, the offside rule still holds, but not when you are two players short.
Similar to Weissing. Now, Chinaglia. He's got one goal tonight. To Wagerly, picked up by Ficus. Ficus stops the shot against the glass, falls to Chinaglia. A shot. Easy save for Jimmy Brown, and look at the way he kills time by pushing that ball high in the air. Well, you couldn't really see it.
We should point out that should the Cosmos score, Chicago would only be able to bring one player off the bench.
Right.
I should say out of the penalty box.
Right. Carlos Alberto, a shot deflected. Moyer scissors it into the stands. Now it'll be a goal kick for the Sting, and they have killed off 56 seconds.
One thing this does is the goalie really needs to stay back. You'll quite often see the goalie come all the way out, as Brissick is doing now, to field the ball and put it back into play. But the goalie must stay in the net because Jim Brown could just kick that ball the length of the field in the air, being two men short.
Chinaglia out in front of G to Chinaglia, but he lays it behind him. Now, it isn't like hockey. Everyone doesn't have to clear the zone because there are no offsides for players. So they can just stay there and wait for Chinaglia to give it back. Carlos Alberto now. Sting has killed a minute and 20 seconds. A shot and a score by Chinaglia. The Sting had killed off a minute and 26 seconds. But now the Cosmos lead 4-2 on the second goal of the evening for Chinaglia. And the Sting will be able to put one player back on. That'll be Greg Ryan.
Here we have the replay. A very well-hit ball by Chinaglia. You'll notice Jim Brown is screened by two Chicago players. Right there, Derek Spalding was playing the ball, and Chinaglia just shot it to the right of Derek, right into the near side. Very little chance for the goalkeeper.
So the Chicago Sting now will have the kickoff. They're one man short. Ryan is on the floor with Ficus, Spalding, and Katsoukas out in front of goalkeeper Jimmy Brown. The Cosmo power play is still in effect. Ricky Davis and Nelson Moraes have joined that power play. Giorgio still on the floor. Spalding sends it the length of the floor, down to Bursic.
And of course, 25 seconds still left on the bench penalty to Willie Roy, which Dieter Ferner is serving in the box right now.
Wagerly. Can't get around Katsoukas, comes back to Davis, to Chinaglia, to Davis. Marias on the far side, the shot against the glass. Chinaglia chops down on the return, didn't get much on it. Jimmy Brown flings it upfield. 2 minutes are gone. That the second Chicago Sting player will be able to come on as soon as I think play stops. I don't think he can.
He should be able to come out right
sure,
now. I don't
right.
know what the holdup is.
Steve Moyers, Katsoukas.
There you have Dieter Ferner sprinting across the field. Ingo Peter coming back on. So Chicago only gave up one goal during that 4 minutes.
Not too bad. The Cosmo lead is only two goals, and we know that that really is not a substantial lead in indoor soccer. 2.5 minutes gone in the period. Charlie Ficus with it to Spalding. Ingo on the near boards. He goes to Katsoukas. He's got a big shot. Coming, shot. Oh, just missed wide. Ingo now. Cosmos substituting Bandoff. Getting him in the game. Spalding fighting for it. Gets to Ingo. To Ficus. He's got a shot. And he missed wide too. Ingo and Tasso. Just inches apart. Charlie Ficus. Here comes De Matthaeis now for the Cosmos, moving right to left. Boy, we came close to equalizing this game in the last couple of seconds. Ricky Davis. Ryan trying to clear it out to Ficus. Tasso Katsoukas with it now. Missed by inches just moments earlier. 4-2, the Cosmos lead it. 11.5 minutes to go in the second period. Charlie Ficus with it. He's got Ingo on the near boards. Picked up by Davis. Against the glass. Katsoukas on the far side. Back to Ficus on the point. To Ingo. Bandoff covering up. Ingo pulls it back. Comes forward to Katsoukas. Tries to settle it. His shot. It goes up into the crowd, and it's going to be a goal kick for the Cosmos.
No, actually, it'll be a corner kick. I think for Chicago, that ball was deflected into the crowd there, and it was fortunate for the Cosmos that it was deflected because Tasso got off a wicked shot.
Reminder, the Chicago Sting's next game on television will be Wednesday, December 23rd at 8 p.m. The Sting plays the Tampa Bay Rowdies right here on WFLD, Channel 32. the home opener, a week from Friday night, the 18th against Montreal. You don't want to miss it at the stadium. There's a shot, Mangle Peter, and he hits a home run. He puts it right up at the top of the stands. Now that'll be a goal kick. It's still 4-2 Cosmos.
It's interesting. When Chicago got the first two goals and had the two-goal lead, Chicago seemed to sit back a little bit on defense there and gain their breath. It appears now the Cosmos, they have a two-goal lead now, and now all the action has been in front of their net the last minute and a half.
Versich, pass to Matthaeis. Ryan working well, fighting DeMatteis for it. Ryan goes down. We're going to have a penalty call.
And I think he'll send him off for 2 minutes simply because the foul occurred right near the boards.
Do you have a feeling that maybe Dave Socher is making up a little bit, Kenny, for those penalties a little bit at the end of the first period?
Well, if he is making up,
that didn't look that flagrant to me.
He has a little bit. Well, Howard, when the foul does occur near the boards, they are a lot more.
I know
strict.
They try to keep the action away.
Here we have a replay of the fouls there. Ryan pushed the ball. It looked like the player was playing the ball there. And I have to agree with you, Howard. It certainly did not look like that one warranted a penalty.
Of course, I wasn't the one that bounced into the board, so it's easy for me to say. Power play, Chicago. Ingo Peter. The shot broken up, and Carlos Alberto clears it out. So Chicago with a two-minute man advantage. Great way to support the Sting is to join the Fanatics, the official fan club of the Chicago Sting. For more information, call the Sting office, 558-KICK. Wherever we go, there's members of the fan club, every road game. A shot deflected by the goalkeeper, Versich. Ingo Peter gunning to get that third goal for Chicago. Sting trails at 4-2, but they have the power play. Fikas, Ingo, Grinitz is all by himself on the far boards. The shot is rejected.
I tell you, Carlos Alberto's earning his money out there tonight.
Ingo, I think he sees Carl now. He shoots, rejected again. Carl, the return, broken up. Symington fighting for it, can't get there. Grinitz. Gets the glass, Fikas heads it toward the goal, battle for the ball. Coming back to Fikas. 57 seconds left on the penalty. To the Cosmos, Granita, a shot is wide, Fikas against the glass. Symington going for the header, Fikas again, Symington, oh, hits the top of the crossbar. Symington hit the top of the crossbar as Ricky Davis clears it down to the Sting zone. Man, again, another Sting missed by inches.
I tell you, Mark did as good as he could with that one, though, because there wasn't much of a chance. He had to lob it over the goalkeeper.
Ingle Peter gets his own rebound. Grinitz on the far board.
30 seconds
gets
remaining.
It. Fires. Yes! Scores! Carl Grinitz! Almost an impossible angle. His third goal of the year, his first of this ballgame. And the Chicago Sting has cut the Cosmo lead to 4-3.
Good work by Ingo Peter here. Ingo shot about three times in a row, and that time he pulled Alberto's attention as well as the goalkeeper. Gave it to Grinitz, and Grinitz hit it first time. I think it was a little bit difficult for the goalkeeper to pick up the shot right away because Carl did hit that one first time.
Grinitz came into the game tonight, the leading scorer in the North American Soccer League. He had 2 goals and 4 assists in the win over Tulsa. He's picked up a goal and an assist tonight, but right now the main thing is to get this game equalized. We have 9:27 to go. First, both sides at full and equal strength as Marhedic gets around Chinaglia. Davis is there, tries to cut it off, and the goalkeeper bursts grabs it.
Howard, in Tulsa, Chicago's power play did not work at all, but they had four attempts there, and they really looked inept tonight. However, they are 2 for 2. They've converted on both power plays.
Right.
The Cosmos also have 2 power play goals, so we've had 4 power play goals tonight.
Figures, 2 and 2. Spalding loses it to Wagerle. Chinaglia. Goes high with it over the glass and a break two. Boy, the way a big guy like Chinaglia can turn and shoot. Chinaglia, 6'1", weighs 180 pounds, but he plays the game like a little guy.
It was an excellent feat from Wagerle, though, because Wagerle broke down. Brett Hall had that split bit of indecision there, and Wagerle fed the ball through to Chinaglia while Brett leaned towards Wagerle. Chinaglia got it. When you give Chinaglia the ball that far in close to the goal, indoors or out, he's going to score a few goals.
Elbowing call on Bandoff. Marhedic with it. He's got Spalding on the near boards. A shot, and Ricky Davis puts it up into the stands. The Sting would like a 2 minute delay a game, but I'm sure he's not going to get it. That ball just bounced off of Davis. He didn't really try to direct it. It's going to be a kick in for the Sting. Benita on the near boards. You're looking now at Boris Bandoff and Ricky Davis. 4-3. Cosmos lead it up against the glass. Marhedic going for it. Can't do it. Ryan to Grinitz settles it. Back to Spalding. His shot. Rebounds off of Ricky Davis. And finally, Bandoff. High in the air. Chinaglia and Hall collide. Steve Wagerle in the attack zone. Trying to beat Ryan into the corner. Against the glass, punched away by Brown. Benita. Header to Derek Spalding. Otto Marhedek, he's got two tonight for Chicago. Carl Heinz Granica. It's shot, saved by Bursich. Partially screened by Ryan that time.
Partially screened by Ryan, and I think the ball was deflected off of Ricky Davis there.
Now Wagerly coming back. His shot hits the crossbar. It came straight down. It must go all the way over the line, and it didn't. Vandoff. Yes. That was Kapp who took the shot. Mascherarian hasn't seen a whole lot of action tonight. Here comes Katsoukas. Gets around Davis. Davis kind of threw a little hip check there into Tasso. Tasso went down, but there was no call.
Yes, there was a foul there, but Tasso tried to go straight in, and he actually was off balance. I think the whistle should have blown because he eventually fell due to the fact that Davis slid underneath him and did not win the ball.
We have 7:20 to go in the period. Finished a shot rejected by De Matteis up into the stands. Kick in for the Sting just inside the red line.
Howard, you kind of get the feeling since New York had that two-goal advantage. The momentum has now changed, and it's actually gone in Chicago's favor for the last 3 or 4 minutes now.
Comeback foul on Davey Husson gives the ball to the Cosmos. Remember, after that home game coming up against Montreal Friday night at the stadium, all the fans are invited back to the Hyatt Regency, the new home of the Chicago Sting backroom party, the post-game party. You'll meet players, Coach Louis Roy, question and answer period. You can have a lot of fun all at the Hyatt Regency right after all the Sting home games this year. Hyatt Regency downtown. Canaglia, great move, but Hall is there. Look at that Giorgio go right through the crease. You couldn't ask for a better ball than that one, but there was nobody there to convert it as De Matteis was wrestling with the Sting defender. Now Katsoukas. Sting trailing 4-3. Less than 7 to go in the half. Remember, our guest at halftime, the commissioner of the North American Soccer League, Bill Woosman. Davey Husson. Otto. Katsoukas shot bounces off of Kapp. Moyers goes down, and they're going to call Hall. Pushing off by Brett Hall. It's going to give the Cosmos a free kick.
Oh, I don't believe they're going to send him off for 2 minutes here. This is...
Yes, they are. Another penalty. Brett Hall doesn't believe it either. It's a shot of the crowd, and a nice crowd here at Byrne Arena.
Yeah, that certainly was a foul, but Brett Hall and Moyers... Moyers tried to just set up his positioning on Hall. Moyers wanted the ball to his feet, and when the ball was not pushed to his feet, and instead in the path where the player who thought Moyers was going to run for it, Moyers was off balance, and they bumped a little bit. Moyers went down, and he's going to send him off for 2 minutes.
Willie Roy agrees. He can't understand it. Rudy Glenn also very disturbed.
On number 23, Brett Hall.
So it's power play time for the Cosmos once again. Sting penalty covers Ryan, Simonton, Ficus, and Spalding.
Number 23, Brett Hall, for pushing.
6:27 to go in the period. 4-3 the Sting, but the Cosmos have a golden chance here to increase that lead.
And of course, Brett Hall is one of the better penalty killers on the Chicago
right.
club, so when he's in the box, you certainly don't have the advantage of him killing off the penalty.
Get hurt twice. Carlos Alberto to Canaglia, up against the glass. Stopped by Spalding, good position. Gets the glass again. Wagerly. Back to Alberto. To Canaglia, scissor kicks up into the stands. Giorgio loves those scissor kicks. It's an awful hard shot to make an indoor, though.
Yes, it's tremendous understanding, though, between the two players. Carlos Alberto looked straight at Giorgio. He knew exactly what Giorgio wanted, and he just lifted the ball up and laid it right on his foot.
When the Cosmos hosts the Jacksonville T-Men at 7:30 p.m.
Brown drives it upfield. Ryan got his head on it just in time. Had that ball gone all the way through, it would have been an offside call against the Sting. They'd have brought it back to the Sting red line, but Ryan did get his head on it, and now the Cosmos is coming back. Canaglia working with Marias. Goes instead to Moyers. Picked up by Spalding. Derek, good positioning to Sarmington. Wagerly on the steal. Ficus collides, goes down. Ryan fighting for it. Wagerly fighting Ryan. To Ficus, and he drives it upfield, killing off time. 1:06 left on the penalty to Brett Hall. Cosmos with the power play, and Carlos Alberto moves into the attack zone. Wagerly on the far side. Brownie kicks it away. If we can get a close-up of Sting goalkeeper Jim Brown, you're going to see an amazing likeness to Ringo Starr. What? Carlos Alberto. He's got Marias on the near side. Spalding is there. Wagerly. Canaglia. Shot. Broken up. Alberto. The top of the glass. And headed away by Simonton. 26 seconds left of the penalty. Simonton got a hustle. Drives it back upfield. Bursic wisely came out, or else Symington might have been able to follow that up with a breakaway. 16 seconds left as Alberto goes inside to Chinaglia. Nelson Moraes kicked away. Carlos Alberto coming back once again. Drives it up against the glass. Wagerly is there. A shot rejected. Penalty is over. Paul is back on the floor. The Sting penalty killers have done their job. We have 4 minutes, 18 seconds remaining as Hall gets the ball in the attack zone, coming in on Alberto. Where'd that Hall go? Against the glass, Balding fighting. Oh, if just another inch or two, Derek would have been able to push it through. But Derek. Here comes Moyers to Chinaglia. Pike is covering. Moyers and the goalkeeper Bursic collide. Moyers is there, a shot. Nice save, the return blown by Wiggerly. Good recovery by Brown, and here comes Rudy Glenn. Coming in on Alberto, looking for a little bit of help. He's got Ingo Peter with him. His shot is rejected by Carlos Alberto. It goes now to Ficus. Cosmo defenders coming back. Ficus looking for Ingo up on the far side. Tries to go through instead to Katsoukas, and the Cosmos are able to clear the zone. Katsoukas coming back fast, but he can't get it. Now here's Knight. Sting had an opportunity there. Just couldn't get the right pass at the right time. Less than 3.5 to go in the half. Howard Balson here with Kenny Stern. Hope you're enjoying all the action. One of several games will be coming to you. Chicago Sting Indoor Soccer on WFLD. Channel 32. Moyers and Hall. Hall gives Moyers a little bit of a bump. Down he goes. And it's going to be a free kick, but I don't think it'll be a penalty. Socha came running over. He's got 5 seconds to put the ball in play on a free kick, or else it's a delay of game penalty.
See, he should be putting it in play right now. The referee should not be stopping the clock right now.
He just stopped the clock to let Canale get out of there.
In the rule book, it says that the referee is only allowed to stop the clock for substitutions when the ball is kicked into the crowd or following a goal.
Exactly. And there was no reason to stop the clock there for Giorgio Chinaglia to exit the field. Katsoukas fighting two Cosmo players for it. Tasso wins it. But the ball goes by Ficus, and the Cosmos coming back with less than 3 to go in the half. 4-3, Cosmos leading. Ricky Davis. Broken up by Katsoukas, kick in. For Chicago. Check that, New York. Referee is stopping time again.
I think he's going to come over and talk to the assistant referee.
Who is Felix
Kutzmann? They're going to talk over the rules and see what the problem is here.
You know, you can save money if you get a group together and come to a Sting home game. Why don't you call Chuck, Greg, or Mike at the Sting office, 558-KICK, for group rate information. And, of course, they'll be there tomorrow morning promptly at 9.
And $64 for adults. And guarantee you great seats for the rest of this action-packed season.
Of course, Chicago now trailing 4-3, 2 minutes and 45 seconds left here in the first half. It's been quite a first half. I am a little bit concerned, though. This is a long field. Chicago's had to kill off quite a few penalties, and I hope this doesn't take much out of them as the game winds on. The younger players on Chicago have been killing the penalties, you'll notice. Greg Ryan, Mark Symington, Brett Hall, Derek Smalling, although he might not quite classify in that youngster category.
Moyers connected. Almost inches away, Stevie Moyers, and now the Sting trying to get the equalizer before the half ends. Ficus out there with Katsoukas, Hall, Glenn, and Ingo Peter. And now Katsoukas, Glenn breaking up the far boards. Katsoukas controlling to Ingo. A shot deflected by Cap. Ingo still fighting for it. Cap tries to clear. Katsoukas gets it back for Chicago. Inside to Ingo, back to Katsoukas. Leaves it go for Glenn. To Ingo, he's got room, a shot, saved by Bursic. Up into the crowd, corner kick for the Sting.
Howard, we have not seen much of Karl-Heinz Granitza here in the first half.
Chicago, corner kick.
That's true, Kenny.
Here you see Ingo crank off a real torpedo. If you want to score indoors, it's a lot easier if the ball is low than it is to score high because the goalkeeper has an easier time reacting on those high shots.
Tries to go inside the glass, the shot by Ingo just misses wide. Ingo missing up top of the crossbar. Greg Ryan now to Glenn, tries to go to Ryan, kicked away by Bandoff. To Daryl G, to Bandoff. Less than 2 minutes to go in the half. Katsoukas trying to force the intercept, can't do it. Now Cap to the near side to G. To Bandoff. Trying to get around Ryan. Ingo Peter is there, he's strong. Battle for it against the near boards. Ingo tries to come out with it, but Ryan is there. The ball really running fast on the carpet, a long lead to Moyers. Brett Hall trying to cover. Moyers and Hall go down. There's no call. Moyers touches it with his hand. There's no call.
And now Rudy Glenn up to Katsoukas, overleads him, but Kunitsa now is on the floor in response to Denny Stern's question. Katsoukas to Kunitsa, broken up by Vandoff, and Katsoukas goes down. Minute and 14 seconds to go in the half. 4-3 Cosmos. Moyers in the attack zone, looking for G. Goes instead to Vandoff, and he closes his opportunity. What a golden chance. Got a good ball for Moyers.
I think he was thinking about passing the ball. When you get that far close, you certainly want to get a shot off.
Out in front, Simington gathers it up. This is Davey Husson. To Spalding, but it's there from the striker spot. The shot doubled up by Versich. Less than a minute to go now. And Moyers goes down. Ryan puts him down. Let's see if Ryan will go. No. Ryan was complaining, and you can see Socha saying, come on. See if Ryan will go. No. Ryan was complaining, and you can see Socha saying, come on, come on, come on. Pushing call. No different than the call that sent Brett Hall to the penalty box a little bit earlier.
Certainly true.
4-3. Cosmos lead. 43 seconds to go in the half. Cap to Davis. Interception by Ryan. Moyers trying to come up behind. There's a long lead to Granitza, but the keeper will beat him to it. And he kicks the ball up into the air to Moyers. Ryan on the intercept. Greg is coming. Shot rejected. Marias is there, and he gets it up to G. 26 seconds left. Back to Nelsy Marias. Now to Earhart Kopp. A shot saved by Brown. Flings it toward Granitza, trying to get position on Davis. It takes a pretty good shot from Cap right into the thigh. No call. G was it to Simington, to Granita, to Husson. Broken up by Ricky Davis. There's no time left. There's the horn. First half has come to an end with the score. The Chicago Sting 3, the Cosmos 4. We'll be back with our halftime show after these messages. This is Howard Balson back again at the Byrne Arena in the Meadowlands, East Rutherford, New Jersey. It's halftime, the Sting trailing the Cosmos by a score of 4-3. And our guest, the commissioner of the North American Soccer League, Phil Wisdom. Phil, it was a great outdoor season. And of course, being a Chicago broadcaster was even greater for us with the Sting going out of the Soccer Bowl. But all in all, there was a lot of competition, some tremendous playoff games. Then, of course, there were some of the consolidation with some of the shakeout of some perhaps the weaker franchises. What would you say right now is the current state of the North American Soccer League?
Well, you're always to see sorry to see franchises not continue. All those people have done a very valuable service to the sport in North America. At the same time, we have to recognize that the clubs that are left, the 14 clubs that are going to operate this next year, are the strong franchises. For the last 4 years, we've had an average attendance of about 14,000 in the league. I really believe that with the strong franchises remaining, a good scheduling situation at this particular time, our average will increase to something like 18. I think the league is going to be much stronger. You know, many sports say this, if we had less teams, the quality of the product would be stronger. The good teams are continually going to be coming into town, and therefore it's going to be a better spectacle from a spectator point of view. We think that's going to happen with the North American Soccer League in 1982.
So actually, there is a possibility if a city could get themselves a really strong franchise, lots of financial backing, a good stadium, you would entertain perhaps another city or two.
The ideal number, I think, from our point of view was 16. We had one or two surprises at the end. We didn't expect them not to continue, particularly Minnesota, because they've done so well in the past. But at the same time, we're not planning to expand and go anywhere near back to where we went before, to 24 franchises. That was a mistake on our part to go to 24. This is the correct number because you become familiar with the teams, familiar with the players, and therefore your attendances go up.
Phil, the marketing experts around the country all seem to agree on one thing. The future of professional soccer really lies with the Americanization of soccer. I know the North American Soccer League and your marketing arm in your office is continually doing a lot to bring up the level of Americans, young people playing soccer. Could you tell us a little?
Almost 2 million, I would say, in Canada and the United States playing the sport. And I would think within another 5 years, we'll have more playing soccer at the youth level than any other sport. And the good thing about it is that both boys and girls are playing it and suddenly enjoying it. Obviously, that's where the future lies. That's where our players are going to come from. That's where the ticket buyers are going to come from and the television viewers. So it's a very important aspect of the development of the game. It takes a little while for us to feel the impact at the professional level in regards to what's happening at the youth level.
Certainly.
But it's certainly going to happen in the second part of the 80s. I'm very confident of that.
Sounds good. And I know there's hundreds of thousands of Chicago fans hearing your words feel pretty good about it too. Phil, thank you very much for joining us. Our guest at halftime, the commissioner of the North American Soccer League, Phil Woosdom. This is Howard Volson sending you back to our studio for this message before we come back for the second half of action with the Sting trailing 4-3. Getting ready to go. Second half action. The Sting will kick off with Spalding, Granica, Symington, Hall, and Ingo Peter out in front of Jimmy Brown. The Cosmos with Canalia, Wagerly, Iarushi, who hasn't played too much tonight. Carlos Alberto and Ricky Davis out in front of Dave Bursich. Ingo Peter, Sting trailing 4-3 against the glass to Spalding. Symington to Ingo, but the whistle has blown.
Yes, what it hit was the glass behind the Cosmos bench. The referee finally figured things out. Of course, the benches are left open, and there's glass behind the benches to protect the fans from a shot coming off too hard.
Spalding against the glass. Symington, Spalding, Symington is down. A shot is rejected up at the sand. Mark's okay. He just got down to, I think, let room for Spalding to fire away. The Sting Soccer Caravans will be starting next month in suburbs around Chicago. For information on the caravan nearest you, call the Sting office, 558-5425. These are terrific. Adults and children alike love those caravans. Carl Granita out in front. Broken up by the Cosmos. Ingo Peter still fighting for it. Ian Wagerly, two number 14s go to the boards. Looks like an obstruction call coming up. Indirect free kick for the Cosmos. Alberto will take it. Cosmos moving left to right, wearing all white uniforms. Blue, green numerals and trim. The Sting in black with yellow numerals and trim. With that Symington fight. Now he goes to Ingo Peter. The shot. It's the glass. Symington the return. A glass. Ingo lets it go. Granita ties it up. Carl Heinz Granita has tied it up. We got a 4-4 game, and Carl, his second goal of the game.
Yes, you got to give a lot of credit to Mark Symington and Ingo Peter. Mark fought all alone in the boards and regained it. He got it to Ingo Peter, and then Ingo, there you can see the first shot's wide. Mark will return it up against the glass. Ingo Peter will fake the shot and leave it for Karl-Heinz Granica. He very patiently waits for it and then fires it hard into the goalie's left-hand corner. No chance again for the goalie, Brisick. We got a 4-4 game.
Brand new game. The equalizer came with just about a 30 seconds gone in the third period. So we're starting all over again. And Wagerly to Canalia. Little Brett Hall on Canalia against the glass. Jim Brown almost had that one slide under him.
Yes, certainly. So when that hits the boards over there, it takes a different carom every time. And that time it stayed along the boards and Jim had to recover. He came out to play it out wide and he had to recover to prevent that ball sneaking in the net.
Ingo Peter with it. Rejected by Davis. And now Canalia on the run. Out to Wagerly. Hall picks up Wagerly as Spalding stays with Canalia. Steve Wagerly from South Africa. Outstanding with Tampa and with the Cosmos. To Ricky Davis. To Wagerly. Ingo Peter fighting Wagerly again. The 14s go to the boards. Wagerly a little bit too much speed. Does got the muscle. Wagerly the wheels. To Iarushi. Slams into Granitz and Hall kicks it out of danger. The magic man, Panomar Hedek, with two goals is on the boards for Chicago. As Alberto goes to Wagerly. Pano gets it back, overruns it, Cosmos collected. They go to Canalia. He's got an angle with Hall. He gets around Hall. Here comes Giorgio, stopped by Brown. Brett Hall with it now as De Matteis comes on the floor, replacing Iarushi for the Cosmos. Now Fike is coming on for Chicago. Vinicius shot, rejected by Alberto.
Howard, the Cosmos are a man short right now.
To Bursich, rolls it around the board. No, they have 5 men out there.
No, they had a substitution problem there. Oh. Chicago had about 15 seconds. They didn't realize they only had 4 players on the field.
Matthaeis wasted a nice run up the floor by kicking it up into the seats. The Sting's going to have a goal kick. Less than 13 minutes to go in the third period. We're tied at 4. 2 goals by Granica. And 2 goals for Panomar Hedek. Those are the Sting's 4 goals. So Carl Heinz Granica, the leading scorer in the indoor, coming in. Nice pass by Chinaglia, but right through the crease. De Matteis couldn't get down on it. Now Ricky Davis. They're opening things up on the defense so Brown can follow the ball as Davis goes to De Matteis. Out front, a shot and a score as Brown committed himself and the loose ball came back to Nelson Moraes and the Cosmos resumed the lead.
And I talked about it just moments ago, that ball will take a different carom off the boards all the time, and that time it snuck in behind the goalkeeper Brown and Moraes had an easy time knocking it into the net.
Nelson Moraes, he's the fellow that scored it. Now the Sting with Marhedic, Renica, Katsoukas, Ryan, and Fikas once again trying to battle back. Ryan at the midfield. Ball stolen away by De Matteis. To Moraes. To Cap. Against the glass, a shot to score by Boyers. It's now another two-goal lead for the Cosmos. They led by two earlier, and they've got their two-goal lead back again. 6-4, that was Boyers' first goal of the game.
I think perhaps the goalkeeper has to be a little shaken when they score two goals from that close in. That time the ball was played instead of off the boards, off the glass, and it came down right to Moyers in front of the net.
Still plenty of time left. 6-4. Cosmos lead it. But the Sting has been battling back for about 2 years now. And now the referee, Socha, wants them to restart the kickoff. Fikas out there with Marhedic, Glenn, Ryan, and Husam. Fikas. Battling Moraes. Here comes De Matteis, he loses control, and he shoves Rudy Glenn down. The reserve referee, Fuchsman, is saying the ball should go to the Cosmos, but he's being overruled, I believe, is he?
Yes, you're absolutely right, Howard. The assistant referee says Rudy Glenn was pushing, and he's pointing in favor of the Cosmos, but the assistant, and they are going to give it to the Cosmos.
Brown pushes it up to Marhedic. Too far for Pato. Glenn fighting for it. Glenn comes out with it. Rudy on the run. To Fikas. Sting needs two. Through the legs to Husan. Marhedic. Ryan with it. Bounces it back to Jimmy Brown. Swings it out to Davey Husan. Perpetual motion on the run. Davey with Fikas. Charlie's got it. Looks for Pato. Kicked away from him. Ryan trying to cut it off at the pass. Down goes Moyers. And we're having a foul called up.
The referee finally got it the right way there. Moyers obstructing on Greg Ryan. And although Moyers went to the ground, Greg, the referee ruled that Moyers prevented Greg from getting to the ball.
Rudy Glenn. Mike Conklin's here with Chicago Tribune. Mike Davis, Chicago Sun-Times. Greg Ryan on the far side tries to walk around Moraes. Oh, he takes a slam into the boards. Moraes gives him another shot. Now Fikas goes to help out. Ryan still fighting. Fikas tries to go against the glass. Ryan tries to go through, broken up. Moyers comes to help out along with Glenn. They collide, and we're going to have a foul called against Rudy Glenn, I believe. Or is he going to call a drop? Could be a drop ball. No,
he's
the ball is going to go
against him.
Puts it in play. Wants to do it again. He wants to restart it.
Howard, I tell you what, the referee is confusing everybody with his hand signals. I don't know why he would restart it, though, here. He's got Davey Husan.
Glenn goes to Husan. The header just misses wide. Return Fikas, broke it up. And back to Greg Hall. Brett Hall, the toy bulldog in the midfield. To Husan. To Glenn. Tries to get by Wagerly. Marias controls. Coming up the near side to Canalia. Kicked away by Brett Hall. Fikas and Canalia go to it. Charlie comes out with it. Back to the goalkeeper, Brown, looking for an open man. There is nobody open. He flings it upfield toward Glenn, but way beyond everyone. Glenn on the run. Keeper's coming. Eskandarian cuts it off. Glenn's going to get it back. Looking for a little help. Oh, he sent it back past the point. Husan hit the midfield. To Fikas. Marhedic standing at the top of the box. Husan to the glass. And Bursich, the good save because Glenn was parked at the doorstep. 6-4, Cosmos lead it. 10 minutes to go in the third period. Wagerly on the run. Walks by Marhedic. Canalia, shot deflected by Hall. Up into the crowd. Looks like almost just about a corner kick. Probably be a kick in. Not quite close enough for a corner kick.
Well, you got a replay. Wagerly actually trying to shoot, and he got the pass off, and Canalia with a good chance. That's interesting. Earlier, Wagerly tried to pass the ball, and he scored on it, and this time he was trying to shoot, and he almost got an assist.
At halftime, the Cosmos led it 4-3. They've tallied twice. The Sting once out in front of Chinaglia. Run off the ball. Gunitza fighting for it, but Davis is there. Boris Bandoff, a shot, just misses. Return, kicked away by Pardo Marhedic, and Gunitza has it. Gunitza coming with Pardo Marhedic. Davis trying to pick his pocket from the back. Pikus to Carl Heinz. Otto moving, tries to go through, kicked away. Hall and Chinaglia collide. Ball goes high in the air, and Bertic is there. Brings it out to Bandoff. Bandoff could have a breakaway. 2-on-1. Here comes Chinaglia to Bandoff. Two Cosmo players sandwiched. Little Brett Hall. And it looks like Chinaglia came out the worst for it. But here comes Spalding on the run. Trying to get by Davis. And we're going to get an obstruction, or will it be a pushing call on Spalding? It's going to be pushing on Spalding.
And Derek very angry at the referee there. He felt he had played the ball through, and Ricky Davis obstructed. Maybe we'll be able to tell right here. There you see Derek. He's going to push the ball past Davis.
Davis wouldn't let him get the ball.
Certainly was close to an obstruction.
And the shot. Good save by Brown. Off by a shot by Giorgio Chinaglia. Giorgio a little disgusted. Good move by Jimmy Brown. And here comes Ingo Peters. Long lead. He has Gunitza. Can't quite control it. He was trying to get it to Spalding. And now Wagerly back to Boris Bandoff. Bandoff on the run. To Chinaglia. Shot to score. Brett Hall gave Giorgio Chinaglia much too much room that time. Giorgio with the hat trick tonight. Cosmos have upped their lead to 7-4.
An excellent goal on the part of Chinaglia and Bandoff both. It really started with somewhat of a numerical problem. Brett Hall really had somewhat of a 2-on-1. Chinaglia snuck behind him, and he hit the ball first time. And what this did, by hitting the first time, Gunitza scored a similar goal early. The goalie has no time to set himself up. He just has to hope that he can turn, and the ball might hit him or might go wide.
7-4. Cosmos up by 3, but we still have a long way to go. 8:44 in this period, and another long 15-minute period. Don't go away. Here comes Ingo Peter. Kicked away. De Matthaeis on the run, looking for Moyers. Goes instead to Iarushi. The shot. Jimmy Brown finally scoops it up as he and Brett Hall mix up their signals. Now Spalding. Simington. Gunitza. Ingo Peter. Gunitza. Great save, Bertic. Carl tried to just finesse it in, and Bertic was able to make the leg save. Off the scene. Adrenaline isn't pumping now. It never will. There's Matthaeis. To Alberto. Just off the glass. Spalding kicks it out of danger. Iarushi. Against the glass. Simington. Over to Ingo Peter. Back to Simington. The birthday boy. Back to Ingo. Picked up by Alberto. His shot rejected. Simington tries to head it back. Put it in play, but it's pushed out of there. Now Moyers punched away by Jimmy Brown. Beautiful play by Brown.
Howard, you should have a 2-minute penalty here against the goalkeeper Brown.
He's
the referee did not see it. He's going to ask the assistant referee. Jimmy
time
really had to do that though, because otherwise it would have been a goal. Chicago got caught in the middle of a substitution there. Brett Hall went on and nobody came on, and that was an intentional handball on the part of Jimmy Brown. Once he's out of the box, he has the same rules.
That's
and
right.
Restrictions
he
as
cannot
a field
use
player.
His hand anymore once he's out of the box. And we have the foul called, a direct free kick for the Cosmos. As Brown, he was willing to sacrifice the free kick, though, because he doesn't control the ball. All Moyers has to do is tap it behind it.
It certainly should be more than a free kick. It should be a 2-minute penalty because it is an intentional handball.
I agree.
And that's what he's telling Coach Willie Roy right now. Somebody's going to have to serve the penalty.
Willie Roy very upset. There
you
it is.
You can see it certainly on the replay. Jimmy Brown got way up in the air, and there was nobody behind him, and he's either going to let that ball bounce and Steve Moyers is going to knock it in, or he's going to have to punch it away and give up a penalty.
Goalkeeper does not have to sit out his own penalty. Rudy Glenn will serve it. So the Cosmos, with a 3-goal lead, now have the power play opportunity. You know, the Sting softball team was undefeated. You can see now the basketball team. The Sting has a basketball team. We'll tell you about it in a second. There's a shot kicked away by Spalding. They go to Simington. Too bad. If they'd have gotten that one through, Mark would have had a shorthanded breakaway. Sting shorthanded. The shot. This is wide. Wager. Kicked away. Wagerly again. Simington on him. Simington wins it and pushes it back over the red line. 20 seconds gone on the penalty. Rudy Glenn serving it for the goalkeeper. Steve Moyers on the deflection up into the crowd. Sting will have a goal kick. On Monday, December 14th at 7 p.m., this is coming Monday, the Sting front office and players will take on the Radio All-Stars. Chucky Swirsky and Les Gravesy and all that gang in a basketball game at Fenton High School in Bensonville. The winner will play the Fenton High School faculty. Now Greg Ryan goes down. Referee is calling the foul on Moraes. Moraes says, okay, okay. Sting shorthanded. They've killed off a minute and 33 seconds. Check that, they've killed off 33 seconds. They go to Symington. Back it comes. Symington trying to step through. He's fighting for it. Makes a good move on Wagerly. Simon is still coming. He's got Greg Ryan with him. Short-handed goal. Beautiful move by the Sting. And look at Bursted scream at Daryl G, the rookie. Mark Symington gave himself and the Sting a little birthday present by walking in on Bursted. There, go watch this one, Kenny. Beautiful.
He simply threw Bursted out. He hit it to Greg Ryan. Greg hit it first time into the net. What you had here was the Cosmos with five attackers on the field on their power play trying to score. And, of course, when things broke down, nobody thinks like a defenseman. Everybody's thinking, I'll run up and let him play it to me, which is normally what happens, but you had no defenders out there.
Now it's 7-5. The Sting has cut the lead to two shorthanded. Ryan, his third goal of the year, first of the game. Sting's first shorthanded goal. Now Waverly up against the glass. Canalia, good save by Jimmy Brown. Look at Giorgio screaming and yelling.
They're going to call a handball.
Handball is going to be a
penalty.
We're going to have a penalty kick, I believe. Brown is screaming. Fikas is screaming. But it looks like they've called a penalty kick.
I tell you, it seems to me that Giorgio called for the penalty kick.
He sure did. Giorgio will take it. He's got three goals already.
What happens here, the referee is escorting Derek Spalding into the penalty box.
I guess Spalding must have said
something.
And
it is significant here because, I'll get to this in a second if I can.
Spalding is pointing his finger to his head.
Okay, what happens is the referee sends him off for 2 minutes, and if he scores, a player comes back on. But yeah. Now the player will be Rudy Glenn, who only has a minute left, and then Chicago will have to kick kill two more minutes.
Canalia, good save, the header misses. Brown has saved the penalty kick. And away Jimmy Brown, Ringo Brown has saved Canalia's penalty kick.
Chicago now must fight it off again with only three players out on the field.
And Wagerly puts it in the seats. We have 45 seconds left on the penalty to Rudy Glenn and a minute and 45 left on the penalty to Derek Spalding, and we never did see the handball call.
Howard, I'll tell you, no matter what, this is a terrible, terrible call by the referee because there's no way Derek Spalding could intentionally handle that ball. The referee may rule that if Derek's hand was not there, it would have gone in the, and then he gives a penalty kick, but why does he send him off for 2 minutes? I don't know.
Fikas and Marias collide, and Jimmy Brown gets the ball out in front. Ryan to Hall. Out to Fikas, the Sting, playing three defenders against five attackers with Fikas, Paul, and Ryan, three young Americans. Wagerly throw a shot, score, Canalia. His fourth goal of the game. Cosmos up the lead to 8-5, and now Rudy Glenn is on, but there's still a minute and 20 seconds left on the penalty to Spalding. 5:48 to go in the third period.
Of course, Rudy was sitting out the penalty to the Chicago goalkeeper. There's the shot. Once again, a first-time hit by Canalia.
Giorgio's got four. The Sting has been hurt by these double penalties where the Cosmos have scored twice now when they've had a two-man advantage.
Howard, it's really too bad Chicago King could not kill off another 20 seconds because then they would have players on the field as it is now. They got to kill off another minute 20.
Brown drove it forward. It went It'll up into the seats.
It should be a drop ball. It came off of the referee.
That's what I thought, too. Marias de Matthaeis. Marias, Carlos Alberto, Stings has to still go off a penalty. Ingo Peter has joined the penalty killers. The shot broken up by Fikas. Taken back by Hall. He's got a man breaking upfield, Ryan, but nobody saw him. Now Ingo killing off time. He goes to Fikas coming up the slot. Minute left on the penalty to Spalding. Fikas coming with Ryan. The Sting has a shorthanded shot goal for this period. It's 8-5. Coming is Ingo Peter. Ball popped over his head to Wagerly. Good move. Wagerly moving now. Ryan covers up. A shot. Good save, Brown. Kicked away by Fikas. Jimmy Brown, quick reactions that time. 41 seconds left now on the penalty to Spalding. Scoreboard shows 7-5, but I'm sure it's 8-5. 5 minutes left in the period. Nelson Moraes with it. Now to Canalia. To Carlos Alberto. De Matthaeis had come out of position. as Brett Hall clears the ball upfield. 16 seconds left now on the penalty. Here comes Moraes. Giorgio Chinaglia. The shot. Jim Brown screened off. Chinaglia, his fifth goal. Brown had Boyers and Mikas right in front of him. Never saw the shot by Chinaglia. It's now 9-5, although the scoreboard shows 8-5. We have 9. 5 goals for Chinaglia.
Here's another look at it. Of course, I talked about it earlier. When you shoot the ball low, you have an excellent chance of scoring. This is a long shot. You won't see many goals scored from here. Jim Brown simply never saw the ball. You know, you may wonder, that was quite a long shot. Jimmy maybe should have gotten himself in a little better position where he could have had a view of things happening, but it's so hard for the goalie indoors.
We have 4:37 to go in the third period. Sting trailing by 4 now, but there's still time. I know people might laugh if they're not used to indoor soccer, but 4 goals can be made up very quickly. Ingo Peters' shot is deflected against the glass. Hall tries to head it toward the goalkeeper. Loose ball. Boyer's going for it. Ingo Peter is going to go for 2. No, just a foul, not a penalty, but De Matthaeis felt it as he limps.
Let's see what happened. The ball is bouncing. I tell you, it looked to me like Ingo Peter got the ball. That's what Ingo was telling the referee. The ball could not have gone in that direction if it had come off of the Cosmos player.
Now Ingo Peter on the far side, picked up by Vandoff. De Matthaeis stayed in the game. Now Glenn, Sting has a lot of work to do. They trail by 4, up against the glass. Marhedic is ridden off the ball by De Matthaeis. Good defensive work by De Matthaeis. Long lead toward Moyers. Red Hall steals it from him. The Toy Bulldog up to Spalding. Less than 4 to go in the period. Sting trailed by 4. Ingo Peter against the glass versus gets it. Sting led this game with 1 time, 2-0. Cosmos then went ahead. Sting tied it up. Cosmos have now taken a lead. A lot of goals coming on penalties. How many power play goals, Kenny, the Cosmos got tonight?
The Cosmos actually with 4 power play goals tonight. Chinaglia now with, 5 goals scored by Chinaglia.
Ingo Peter takes an elbow from Wiggly, takes a shoulder from Wiggly. Ingo looking for a little bit of help. Sees Rudy Glenn, pushes it out to Big Rudy. Here he comes. Spalding on the far boards. Vandoff covering. Spalding tries to go inside. Vandoff heads it into the crowd. Spalding looking for maybe a delay of the game call. None coming. Kick in for the Sting. Hall back with Moyers in the defensive zone. There's Derek Spalding getting ready to put the ball into play. Against the glass. Comes out around to Vandoff. Spalding is there. Kicked away. Wagerly. To Vandoff. Looking for Moyers. Weak shot by Vandoff. He's had several opportunities. Can't seem to hit the ball hard. Wouldn't like it too much if I said that. Rudy Glenn, good defensive play. Here comes Rudy out with it. He's got Ryan on the far side, Pato on the near side. Into the attack zone. Greg Ryan, nice move. A shot, deflected in front. Return, no good. Oh, and Glenn puts it by Ryan, and there's the return by Symington. He puts it halfway up into the stands. Goal kick for the Cosmos.
And the goalkeeper, Brisich, down. He's hurt. He's in a lot of pain. I'll tell you what, he's more than just acting right here. I don't know how Chicago prevented getting the ball in the net. There's Rudy. He waits. He lets the defender come at him. It was a 3-on-2. He gives it to Greg. A super move on the part of Greg Ryan there. And there he hits it. A great save by the goalkeeper. It hits the cross by Rudy Glenn. Misses. I'll tell you how he hurt himself.
Right into the side post.
He slid right into the side post. He is in pain.
Kenny, you made a statement at the beginning of this period that the third period, when the blowouts happened, the score was 4-3. The Cosmos have tallied 5 times in this period, the Sting only twice.
Yes, certainly so. It happens quite often. Chicago's looked very tired here in the third period. This is when the tired team sometimes will drag a little bit. Chicago played a game Saturday night. Now they are playing again Tuesday. The Cosmos are a little bit fresher. And
well, we still have a long fourth quarter to go. Remember, the Sting will be opening the home season at the stadium Friday night, December 18th, against the Montreal Manic. It's going to be Budweiser night as a stretcher is being brought out here for David Bursich. Budweiser Day, the first 10,000 fans will receive a present from Budweiser. Tickets to all Sting games are available at the Sting office. Kenny?
Howard, watch the goalkeeper right here slide across the net and catch his foot on that post, trying to make the save.
His left ankle went right into it.
That is a bad, bad injury. I think
probably
in
slow motion, it's hard to tell, but if you saw that thing live, he went into it full speed.
If it happened to you, you might, you
might feel it too a little bit. So
now this is interesting. Birkenmeier is going into the nets for the Cosmos, and I don't know that Birkenmeier has ever played indoor.
No, he's practiced indoors. He certainly has not played in any indoor games, but that's not a bad goalkeeper to have as a reserve, is it?
No, I guess not. Birkenmeier. Come on, fans, out and watch the Chicago Sting Friday night, December 18th against the Montreal Manic at the stadium. You can get your tickets at the Sting office, 333 North Michigan. All Ticketron locations at the 333 North Michigan Tobacco Shop. Or call 558-KICK to use your Visa or MasterCard. And, of course, Kenny and I and Jack Jacobson, our producer, all looking forward to December the 23rd when we're going to be down here. Channel 32 cameras will be in Tampa, Florida. We'll be going against the tough Tampa Bay Rowdies with Wes McLeod and Mike Connell and Neil Roberts, Washington Oliveira. And there's Bursich being helped off the field, getting a very nice hand from these Cosmo fans.
Howard, it certainly is a bad sign when they have to carry a player off the field, but at least they did not have to use the stretcher, which they brought out, so that maybe that is a good sign. Basically, all that tells
you is... He's played a nice game, Kenny.
Yeah,
Cosmos, I think, have found themselves a nice indoor goalkeeper. He played a beautiful game while I was in there. I certainly hope his injury isn't serious, and he'll be able to resume action.
Yes, I think actually in the first half, he kept the game close. He made some unbelievably outstanding saves against Chicago, and that kept the game close in time for the Cosmos to come out here in the third period and extend that lead now to 9-5. But, of course, indoors is a funny game, and I really look for this goalkeeper, Birkenmeier. Now, he might have a difficult time. It's a hard situation to come into, coming into an indoor soccer game and being stuck in that shooting gallery.
Kenny said Birkenmeier has practiced with the team. He's never played in a real indoor game before. Well, he's going to get his baptism of fire tonight because the Sting, down by four, they're going to be pouring all over that Cosmo net as Ricky Davis lets it go for Wegerle. Granica fighting for the ball. Carl's got a couple of tonight. Foul called against Karl-Heinz Granica. Gives a free kick to the Cosmos in the midfield near side. Howard Balson here with Ken Stern, hoping you're enjoying the action. Hiroshi. To Wegerle, to Moyers, he's trying to turn, he's got position, a shot, just misses. Wegerle gets it back. Escandarian to Wegerle, picked up by Symington. A shot, good save, Jimmy Brown, he was right there. Brown again looks for somebody to open themselves up, gives it to Rudy Glenn, lets it go for Symington. Teammates at Indiana University a couple of years back. Along with Charlie Ficus, they go to Granica. Granica trying to get in position. A shot saved by Birkenmeier. That wasn't too tough a test. Up he comes to Moyers, cut off by Hall, but that ball is going to pop. No, it stays in play. Davis to Iarussi. Cosmos moving left to right. Minute 24 to go with the third period. Sting trailing 9-5. Five goals by Giorgio Chinaglia. Kenny, I believe one of the reasons Giorgio decided to play indoor was he was a little tired of hearing all the New York publicity about Zunkel. The New York Arrows, and he wants to show people he can score goals too, and he's proving a point tonight.
Yes, he certainly has five goals, not to mention the one assist, so he's got 11 points tonight.
Sting out there now. There's Birkenmeier waiting for the first big rush. Sting there with Ingo Peter, Davey Husson, Brett Hall, Granica, and Ryan. Ingo against the glass. Birkenmeier's out. Ball comes back to the point. Taken away. Here comes Escandarian on the run. Good tackle by Hall, but the Cosmos still come. De Matthaeis in front, Chinaglia, and he blows it. He puts it up into the seats.
Yes, a bad play there by the Chicago defender, Davey Husson. He committed himself, and he really exposed the defense, and then the Cosmos came back 3-on-1. Giorgio trying to pat that field down. They've had a few problems out here tonight. Quite a few times this turf has come up, and I'm sure the Cosmos will try to settle that problem before they play again in this facility.
Brett Hall with it now. Sue Spalding pushed off the ball by Escandarian. Ingo Peter has to go back to get it. Chinaglia fighting. Ingo gets position. Thirty-two seconds left in the third period. Granica to Ingo. The glass. Ingo and Davis go down, and Birkenmeier picks it up. Birkenmeier picks it up. Okay. Sting trying to get at least a goal before the period comes to an end. They only have 22 seconds to do it. Davey Husson on the intercept. He's got Spalding on the far side. Gives it to Derrick. Spalding coming. The shot. Broke it up. Spalding tries to go to Husson. Chinaglia is there. To De Matthaeis. Against the glass. ground from a prone position. Scissor kicks it out, but there's the horn. The third period has come to an end with the Sting trailing by a score of 9-5. We'll be back with what would certainly be an explosive fourth period after these words. Getting ready to go. The fourth period starts. Cosmos kicking off, moving left to right. Spalding breaks up one attack. Canalia gets it back. He's got Wagerly free. The shot, good save. Wagerly back again. Ficus kicks it away. Too far for Hall. Comes back to Wagerly. This unit for the Cosmos, tough to take the ball away from. Canalia is breaking to the box, but they go instead to Bandoff. He's having a rough game tonight. Couldn't control it, and now Mark Symington with it.
Howard, the report we have from downstairs is they are x-raying the goalkeeper, Brissick, for a possible broken leg.
Ball is kicked up into the stands. We're going to have, looks like a corner kick for Chicago. As Cap put that ball up into the stands, trying to defend against Granitza. They're doing a pretty good job of pummeling Carl Heinz down there in front, aren't they?
Yes, and I think I might go up to the stands and find that young gal and sit down next to her if the Cosmos get a few more goals.
Granitza on the corner kick. A shot, broken up. Symington on the near boards. Spalding. To Symington, back to Spalding. At the glass, oh! Carlos Alberto clears it out of the danger. Charlie Ficus almost lost it to Canalia. Boy, you gotta watch that guy. He is all over where. He's chicken man. He's everywhere. Symington tries to go inside. Ficus, all on the boards, can't control it. Alberto does. Just an inch over the boot of Brett Hall. Here comes Wagerly, coming all the way to Alberto. Backheel pass, but Cap, the rookie, did not expect the veteran's pass. Hall looks for Granitza. Cap gives ground. Symington coming up the near side. Hall to Granitza, but a little bit too far. He just waited too long, and the Cosmos take control.
Yes,
they played a minute and a half of this period, Sting trailing 9-5.
Out of all the choices, perhaps Brett took the worst one. I think Carl wanted the ball a little bit earlier there.
Bandoff's pass to Canalia in the corner. Brown is there. Looks for Granitza. It's intercepted by Wagerly. Canalia to Bandoff. Ficus breaks it up. Pushes it through to Wingo Peter. Granitza, Ficus moving up the far boards. They have Brett Hall coming up on the near side. Ingo looks around. Now Ficus. Ingo. Hall. Ingo. Cut off by DiMatteis coming off the bench. Punched away. Against the glass again. Ingo fighting for it. But the Cosmos' DiMatteis is going to clear it. Good timing by DiMatteis. He came off right at the right time that time. Here's Granitza. To Wingo. Needs a little bit of help. Shot is rejected. Wingo gets it back. Through the glass, Granitza. Wingo, open goal. Granitza fighting for it. Now Wingo Peter, and we're going to get a foul.
You certainly have to give Wingo Peter a lot of credit. Chicago down by four goals. Wingo is out there fighting very, very hard, and that almost resulted in a scoring opportunity for Chicago. Here we have a look at the foul. Once again, Ingo got a piece of the ball. The referee ruling that he went through the back of the defender's legs to get at that ball, so he gave the ball to the Cosmos.
And still, there's the long through ball to DiMatteis against the glass, saved by Brown. To Moyers up into the seats. Still, Birkenmeyer, who came into the game for the injured Bursich, has not really been tested. He got one little dribbler, but another. He hasn't had to touch another ball except that one that he punched away.
Howard, 13,983 people came out to see the first Cosmos games, and they've been treated to quite a bit of action, and I imagine by the end of this season, they'll be filling up the stadium for every game.
Just a couple of people under 14,000 here on a rainy night in New Jersey. DiMatteis, a shot missed, a return, broken up, kicked away. Iarushi had a cripple and he missed it. Granitza with it now. He's got Glenn breaking up on the near side. He's got him. Granitza with Marhedic. And Glenn. Granitza. Shot. Kicked away. Birkmeyer. There's a good save. Glenn in the air. Birkmeyer misses on the punch. Ryan. Marhedic to Glenn.
Come on, Teddy. Go there.
To Marhedic. Picked up by Iarushi. To Granitza. Against the glass. Oh, a ball got by Glenn Ryan. Ryan fighting Iarushi for it. And the loose ball comes out to Cap. Steve Moyers. Just over 11 minutes remaining. No scoring in this period so far. The Sting trying to cut into that four-goal Cosmo lead. It's 9-5. New York leads it.
game number two for the Sting. They won the opener, 9-8 in Tulsa. Now they really have their work cut out for them as Escondera and the left-footed drive upfield broken up by Peter. Carol Heinz Benita, past Marhedic to Ingo. The shot gets the glass. Benita shot, grabbed by Brookmeyer. Boyers takes his time. Cosmos are in no hurry. Can't blame him. Here comes Stevie Morris. He has a goal tonight. To Gerald G. A shot misses wide. Moraes collected. To Moyers against the glass. A shot to score by Moraes. Good work by Moyers. He set it up.
Certainly so. You'll notice the Cosmos seem to be getting every bounce off the glass and off the boards. To me, this is a sign that if one team is getting a majority of these bounces, they are usually the fresher team and the more, I don't know how to say, Howard, but there you see the replay, an easy goal for Moraes, a wide open net, and it seems to me, though, that Chicago is just trying very hard to get back in this game, but the Cosmos look like they are just capable of doing a lot more running tonight.
10-5, Cosmos lead it. Moraes' second goal tonight, but the work done by Stevie Morris. Kenny, I want to tell you that I'm impressed by the Cosmos acquisition from California, the young American Stevie Morris.
Yes.
What do you know about Stevie?
Well, he's played with California for quite a few years. He had an excellent beginning of the season 2 years ago in California, scored numerous goals, and then had a collapsed lung or some kind of injury similar to that. And California did not want to let him go because he had a high price tag placed over his head. But now the Cosmos got him in the dispersal draft.
Daryl G. Ricky Davis. Picked up by Glenn. 10-5. Cosmos lead it. Ryan on the intercept. And now the magic man, Marhedic, with two goals, goes to Davey Husson. Back to Pato. Give and go with Davey. Davey's coming against the glass. Brookmeyer covers up. Those boards are either very dead or the Sting's not getting enough zing on them, Kenny, to get the ball back.
There you saw the ball thrown over two lines and landing just short of the third line, so there is no offside.
Meyer started out with the St. Louis Stars back in 1977. North American.
Of course, that was the California organization, and then
they moved to California.
Davey
Husson. Davis with it. Another young, fine American player. Paso Katsoukas, we haven't seen him in a while. On the floor, he's coming. That ball hit the crossbar, the corner of the crossbar. Paso goes down, and a foul called on G. Kenny, I kept waiting for that red light to go on.
Yes, I did also. I think that hit probably right in the corner there in the underside because the ball came straight down just as the Cosmos shot did in the first half. Here you could see maybe a replay of the foul. And Tasso goes, and he gets shoved a little bit. And Tasso knows he's not going to get that ball, so he thinks, if I go down, it's the only chance we're going to have of regaining this one.
Marhedic in front, pushed away by Kapp, taken by Chinaglia, fighting Tasso Katsoukas for it. Tasso not intimidated by Chinaglia. Chinaglia takes the dive, battle for it. No call. Simonton's out. Oh, he misses wide to the far side with that left-footed rocket. Moraes now, Katsoukas. Reyes puts Katsoukas down.
That's
going to
be two minutes.
It's going to be a trip. Katsoukas still on the ground.
Whether or not it was a good call, it certainly did happen right in front of the referee as he got pinned in the corner as well.
8 minutes, 30 seconds left in the game. Sting trimming by five. They can get this power play rolling quickly. Get a quick goal. There is still time. Moyers, a product of the University of Missouri in St. Louis.
30 seconds of the fourth quarter.
As is Cap.
2 minutes.
Carl Benita, there is Chelsea Moraes, fine player, Brazilian, international, played with the Cosmos for many years. There's no chicken anymore, no youngster. The Cosmos wanted his experience back in the indoor. Power play, Ingo Peter, to Ficus, out to Benita, shot, save. Ficus again, the shot, hit Simonton, comes right back. Benita. Oh, he hit the crossbar again. Shot score, Simonton.
That is an interesting goal to watch. Granitza hit the same shot that Katsoukas hit. Ficus hit the rebound, and Mark Simonton jumped over, let the ball go through his legs. He screened the goalkeeper, so the goalkeeper could not hold on to it.
Happy
I think
birthday,
you'll see
Mark
it here.
Simonton.
Carol Heinz, the underside of the crossbar. It comes down. Charlie Ficus to rebound. Mark jumps over the ball. Because he screened the goalkeeper could not hold on to it, and then Mark just knocked it in. Mark had two assists tonight, scores a goal on his birthday.
The Sting power play came just seconds after it started. Now we have 8:04 to go in the ball game. The Sting trailing now by four. That might give Chicago a little momentum. See if we can keep the Cosmos off the board. Ficus fighting for it, gets it. Goes to Karl-Heinz Granica. Now to Ingo. Scores Ingo Peter! His first goal of the season. That makes it 10-7. And fans, this is what we mean. Look how quickly the Sting has scored two goals. The Cosmos lead now by three. It's 10-7. And we still have 7:49 to go.
Yes, excellent understanding. Ingo Peter assisted Karl-Heinz on two goals earlier tonight. So Karl said, I'll return the favor. And he slid the pass to Ingo Peter. And Ingo now has scored his first goal of the season. This is an important time. 7:43 left to go. If Chicago could get another one, then things might get a little nervous.
Of course, that first goal by Simington wiped out the penalty. They're both at full and even strength, but Sting now has scored a couple of goals in a matter of seconds, getting an elbow call against Derek Spaulding. Free kick for the Cosmos. Sting has cut the Cosmo lead to 10-7. That's the kind of action you will see in indoor all season long. And remember, the Sting home on the 18th of December. Oh, we should have had a dangerous play call there, and we did. Dangerous play call against Wagle. He got his foot right up in Ingo Peter's face. Ingo avoids a trip by Alberto. Ingo coming, he's got Granica coming on the near side. He goes to Karl. Oh, too bad. Broke it up by
Chicago's seventh goal, scored by
the Cosmos 14. Defenders, Boris Bandoff. Spaulding tries to go through.
Nine,
Ingo Peter.
Five,
Ingo stands
12,
on it. Brett Hall. Up front. Granica.
Into the final quarter.
But he's run off the ball by Davis. Oh, we came so close again. Spaulding on these breaks.
7-11
the long lead to De Matteis. He has Ficus to beat. Shot to score. He beat Ficus, beat Jim Brown. The Cosmos back to a four-goal lead, 11-7. De Matteis, his first goal of the game.
Well, Charlie let it go. I think he thought the goalkeeper, Jim Brown, was coming out, and perhaps Jimmy should have there because he got caught really in no man's land, and there you can see the ball's pushed in front. De Matteis with a step on Ficus. Jimmy coming off the line a little bit late, and he lifts it over him. A good goal on the part of De Matteis. But once again, what you see is Chicago three goals down. They are trying to push everything forward, and that left the defense exposed.
He came to the United States in April, came over from Italy. He played in the Italian third division back in 78. But the Cosmos saw plenty of them that he liked. Here comes Ficus. It's 11-7, 6:54 to go. Still plenty of action. They go to Hall. Hall tried to go inside to Ficus, broke it up, a shot. Kicked up, oh, Granica hits the crossbar again. Carol Granitz has hit the crossbar twice now in less than a minute, and the ball sails out, kicked by Alberto. That could easily be a two-minute penalty.
Oh,
but
it certainly could be a two-minute penalty. He was caught in the corner, and he lifted the ball downfield. The referee evidently felt he was trying to keep it in play and just hit it a little bit.
11-7, Cosmos. Granitz with it. He has two tonight. Back to Spaulding. Out to Ryan. He's got Iarussi with him. Ryan's still fighting. Iarussi wins the ball. Bobby coming out. There's the long lead to De Matteis coming again. Out in front, broken up by Spaulding. Looking for a little help. Goes back to Jimmy Brown. Now Greg Ryan. To Brett Hall. 6:08 to go in the ball game. Sting down by four. Aldebrandt is just beyond him, and Carlos Alberto is there. To Iarussi. He's got De Matteis on the far side. Hits it himself. Now Giorgio Chinaglia. He's got five today. He's got a hat, a coat, and a shoe trick. Back he comes to Iarussi. Scored. No. There's a score. That one by Chinaglia, number six. Kenny, I didn't see the red light go on, although I thought Iarussi.
Yeah, Chinaglia will get the goal. Iarussi hit the underside of the crossbar, and it came straight down. I believe it landed on the line, and Chinaglia just headed in the crippler.
Six goals for Giorgio Chinaglia. I'm sorry, fans. I called Iarussi's shot a score.
Good play by
Iarussi
there. And there's the shot. Let's see. Yes, it hit the underside of the crossbar, came down, hit the line, and Chinaglia simply outjumped Greg Ryan with his left arm on Greg's shoulder.
Now, Dieter Ferner is coming on for Chicago to play goal. This will be Dieter Ferner's first appearance in an indoor game. Dieter, of course, the hero of the Sting stretch drive in the Soccer Bowl. Those great shutouts of San Diego and the Cosmos, those shootout victories. Well, now Dieter Ferner is in the game for Chicago. Telling the referee that he has come in. We have 5:46 remaining. Cosmos up by five again, 12-7. All right, Chicago, let's see a miracle finish. Are you ready for it, Kenny?
Of course. One important thing here is that Dieter Ferner receives some important experience indoors. Of course, Dieter should be an ideal indoor goalie with his tremendous reactions and recovery.
Dieter
Ferner
is
sent him over to the bench.
He's asked to change jerseys with Jim Brown. Dieter Ferner was wearing a red jersey just like Brinkemeyer. And so the referee wants Ferner to put on a blue jersey.
I tell you what, this is one time, Howard, when I'm absolutely lost. I cannot understand why he would make them change jerseys. They're on opposite ends of the field.
Kenny, you're my crack analyst. You're my expert, man. If you don't know, how a poor guy like me is supposed to know?
Well, the way my mind works, if the referee isn't going to make him switch uniforms outside, why would he make him change inside?
I don't know, Kenny. You got to stop your mind working that way. Here comes Hall. Sting down by five. Still time. Believe it or not, it's that kind of a wild game this is. Hall trying to bring in a cap. Up front. No, he couldn't get enough on it to get it to Wingo Peter.
Yes, this should be a two-minute penalty. Cap knocked Brett Hall right into the boards. I'm not sure whether the referee had a good view of that. The assistant referee had a perfect angle on that one.
Foul has been called against Cap.
Yeah, he's going to take him off for 2 minutes.
Sting will have the power play. 5:34 to go in the game. Sting can cut that Cosmo lead to four. Sting scores tonight. Two for Granita, two for Marhedic. Ingo Peter, Greg Ryan, and a birthday goal for Mark Symington. Happy 23rd, Mark. 12-7, Cosmos. What a great game this indoor soccer is. I mean, never seen a game that can change so fast. And although the Cosmos have been dominating the second half, strangely enough, it's not too late. If this were an outdoor game, you could forget it. Otto Marhedic on the corner kick from the near corner. There's a shot of Erhard Kapp from the University of Missouri-St. Louis on the bench. Great Americans in this game. I mean, the Americans really have found a home in indoor soccer. Both sides have terrific American. In fact, the Cosmos and Sting acknowledge they have the best Americans in soccer. Pika shot, deflected, the return, broken up by Nelson Moraes as Carl Granita tries to put it up in front to Marhedic. Ricky Davis is there. Marhedic coming up behind Davis. There's the long lead to Eskandarian. Pika's back with him, though. Charlie breaks it up.
Howard, Kapp was issued a yellow card. I guess this is his second flagrant penalty of the game in the eyes of the referee, so he gave him a yellow card as well.
Go Peter, off the glass. Sting power play, Ficus, Peter, Granita, Symington, and Marhedic. Ingo Peter calling for a two-minute delay of game call. Referee wasn't buying it. We have Eskandarian, Moraes, Carlos Alberto, and Ricky Davis, the penalty killers. Ficus, the shot, and Davis screens out Berkelmeyer. Ficus, his first goal of the year. Mama Betty and wife Debbie very happy about that, but they'd be happier if the Sting can pull it out. That takes care of the penalty to cap both sides of full and equal strength. The Sting has cut the lead 12-8 with just under 5 minutes.
I think you're going to see one young American helping the others. Charlie shot the ball, and not only did Davis screen the goalie, he helped deflect that ball into the net. You'll notice at the far side of the net is Mark Symington, so if Davis had not deflected that at all, I think Mark would have had the goal.
12-8, 4:56. If the Sting can continue to score at the rate of a goal a minute, and the Cosmos stay off the board, we still got a chance. This probably sounds silly. And I object, too, to announcers that keep saying, don't go away, fans, it's not over. But, Kenny, during the indoor season, strange things happen. Yeah, goals are scored. Tulsa got three or four goals on us in about 3 minutes. There's Spalding on the interception, shot off the glass. Hall goes up in the air. Davis controls. Just the nature of this wild game. It goes to Hall, out in front. Granita, his hat trick. It is now 12-9.
An excellent goal there. Some tremendous work by the young Americans. Mark Symington fed it to Brett Hall. Brett Hall, very unselfishly, will hit Granita in front of the net for the crippler. There you see Davis and Hall. Mark Symington with the ball through the legs to Brett Hall. He finds Granita out in front, and Carl hits it first time with the left foot into the empty net.
The Sting was the leading scorer in indoor soccer last year, averaging...
in the eyes of the referee, so he gave him a yellow card as well.
You go Peter, off the glass. Sting power play, Ficus, Peter, Granita, Symington, and Marhedic. Ingo Peter calling for a two-minute delay of game call. Referee wasn't buying it. We have Eskandarian, Moraes, Carlos Alberto, and Ricky Davis, the penalty killers. Ficus, the shot, and Davis screens out Berkelmeyer. Ficus, his first goal of the year. Mama Betty and wife Debbie very happy about that, but they'd be happier if the Sting could pull it out. That takes care of the penalty to cap both sides of full and equal strength. The Sting has cut the lead 12-8 with just under 5 minutes.
I think you're going to see one young American helping the others. Charlie shot the ball, and not only did Davis screen the goalie, he helped deflect that ball into the net. You'll notice at the far side of the net is Mark Symington, so if Davis had not deflected that at all, I think Mark would have had the goal.
12-8, 4:56. If the Sting can continue to score at the rate of a goal a minute, and the Cosmos stay off the board, we still got a chance. This probably sounds silly, and I object too to announcers that keep saying, "Don't go away, fans. It's not over." But Kenny, during the indoor season, strange things happen.
Yes,
goals
sir.
Are scored. They, Tulsa got three or four goals on us in about 3 minutes. There's Spalding on the intercept, a shot off the glass. Hall goes up in the air. Davis controls. Just the nature of this wild game. That goes to Hall out in front. Finisha, his hat trick. It is now 12-9.
An excellent goal there. Some tremendous work by the young Americans. Mark Simonton fed it to Brett Hall. Brett Hall very unselfishly will hit Granitz in front of the net for the crippler. There you see Davis and Hall. Mark Simonton with the ball through the legs to Brett Hall. He finds Granitz out in front, and Carroll hits it first time with the left foot into the empty net.
The Sting was the leading scorer in indoor soccer last year, averaging just over 8 goals a game. They got 9 goals against Tulsa. They've got 9 goals here. The only problem is the Cosmos have 12. Battle for the ball. In go. Gives it to the goalkeeper. Berner. Out to Mark Symington. He has a goal tonight and a couple of beautiful assists. Over to Wingo Peter. The Sting attacking with Hall on the far side. Benitez on the near side. Symington now at the point. To Hall. He's pushed down. There's no call. Brett looks at the referee and screams. Referee says play on. Carlos Alberto. Broken up by Ingo Peter. Symington back to Ingo. Mark Symington. A shot. Oh, Granito almost got the deflection in, but it hit the top of the glass.
Excellent chance there. All Carl had to do was deflect that ball at the goal, but he hit the glass up above.
Ricky Davis, his shot broken up. Peter Ferner with it now. Sting down by three. 3:25 to go. They need a goal quickly. Carl Heinz Granitza with it now as Greg Ryan replaces Simonton. In go Peter. Granitza, the shot, save, good save, Berkelmeyer, beauty. Ingo with it now to Hall. Marias kicks it away from Hall. Good defensive move by the veteran, Nalty Marias, 30 years old. Very canny player. Steve Moyers trying to go around Spalding, a shot, misses wide. Hey, Matthaeis, Moyers, a shot and a score. Set up by De Matthaeis, Moyers with a good move, however, his second goal. Now it is 13-9.
No chance.
A pitcher's duel.
No chance whatsoever for Dieter Ferner. You'll see the shot is going to be deflected as Dieter guessed right as Moyers was trying to shoot it to his left. And you'll see the ball deflected off the inside of Derek Spalding's left thigh, and it goes into the net. And now it's 13-9, and that
breaks
washes
the average,
away.
Now we need 4 goals in 2 minutes and 53 seconds now. Now it's going to be hard.
Yeah.
Now it's going to be a little bit tougher as Greg Ryan gets the pass from Goodings down the kickoff. Canalia, he only has 6 tonight. He'd like to get a couple more.
Of course, 6 is the record. So Giorgio would like to break the record of 6 goals here in his first game.
Eskandarian, Iarushi, Eskandarian, into the stands. It's like the old Cub infield.
Yes, I think he must
have. Of Hughes to Smalley to the right field stands. That was Eskandarian.
I think he must have had some relatives sitting up there in the stands, and he said, "I'll hit you one there," because I don't know exactly what he was trying to do. He just kicked the ball right into the crowd.
Our producer, Jacobson, here tonight, he remembers that Roy Smalley tremendous throwing arm. Granitza covered by Cap. Carl shot rejected by Cap. Spalding heads it back to Ryan. Weigerly intercepts. Here he comes. Long lead to Canalia. Ferner comes out beautifully. Peter hasn't lost the magic. Ryan is dumped.
That'll
by
be 2 minutes.
Ryan is slow in getting up. That's Greg. No penalty, just a foul. Ryan is down. The Sting put it in play. They have to put it in play within 5 seconds, whether the player's down or not. Glenn puts it in the corner to Hall. Gets by him, and a foul called. This time against the Iarushi. We have 2 minutes and a second to go in the ballgame.
I tell you, Howard, it's funny. Once the Cosmos got 5 goals up, and there you have the shots on goal, Chicago 38 to the Cosmos 37. Once the Cosmos got 5 goals up, how all of a sudden the calls are now all going to Chicago's.
Grenades in front, Ryan shoots, misses. Iarushi with it now, tries to clear. Canalia and Glenn. Run off the ball. Canalia looks for the call to the referee, none coming. Dieter Ferner in the game, replacing Jimmy Brown. Sting had cut the lead to 3 goals. Now it's back up to 4. Glenn coming with Marhedic. Greenies in the attack zone. Goodison calling for the ball. Glenn keeps it. Chicago Marhedic to Hall. Brett shoots. Broke it up. Kicked away. Berkemeyer was down. Sting attackers couldn't get on the ball. Here's Glenn coming with a minute and 20 to go. Glenn, nice dribble. Pushed. To tied. Ew! Nice move by Escandarian. Kicks it away from Pato Marhedic. Wagerly on the run. Brett Hall misses on the slide tackle. Canalia gets it. Back to Wagerly. Up into the stands. Kick in Chicago. Daryl G coming in for Wagerly off the Cosmo bench. 13-9. A minute and 8 seconds to go. Don't forget, the Chicago Sting will be home December 18th, a Friday evening at the stadium to take on the Montreal Manic. Want to have the Sting's home opener be part of your plans and show the soccer bowl champions your support for the indoors. The Sting goes for the sweep. They want to take this indoor too. This one, they just may not pull out, however, but they're going to go for victory number two in Chicago. Ticket information, 558-KICK. Here's Daryl G against the glass. A shot to score, 7 goals. Canalia has broken the NAS all-indoor record in his very first game.
Yes, welcome indoors, Dieter. That time the ball got played behind Dieter Ferner. Dieter overreacted a little bit. Giorgio had a very easy time. Fans, what you're about to see is a record. Giorgio's seventh goal of the game. You can see Dieter overreacted. Giorgio shoots. Watch how quick his arms go up.
Willie Roy on the Chicago bench has been talking to the players, showing them where they're going wrong. More or less using it as a clinic. There he is, the most prolific scorer in the game. Giorgio Canalia, in his first indoor game ever, has just scored his seventh goal. Wow, what a performance. Carl Hanskranitz has had some big performances in terms of combining goals and assists, but there's never been a goal-scoring game like this one.
Howard, it's funny, Giorgio isn't the most popular player in the world, and you'll always find critics that say, oh, he can't in front of the net, he's no good. He's a tremendous player, and the critics all said he won't be any good indoors, he won't be able to play indoors. Giorgio said, I'll be able to play fine indoors, and he scored 7 already.
Remember, our next television game will be December 23rd, evening of the 23rd in Tampa Bay at 8 o'clock, Chicago time, against the Tampa Bay Rowdies, right here on Channel 32. Intercept by Alberto, Hall fights for it. Marhedic. Sting hasn't given up. They go to Rudy Glenn. Shot. Don't. It hit. Glenn shot it. It hit the crossbar. Came out. I think it hit Berkemeyer, didn't it?
No, it hit number two, Escandarian. I think that will probably be scored an own goal if they do have own goals indoors. Rudy got a good shot off. It hit the inside of the post, and it'll come back and catch Escandarian.
It's 14-10. We're only down by 4 with 28 seconds to go.
There's a good pass by Marhedic. Rudy hits it very hard with the left foot. Straight back into the defender and into the net.
14-10. Now the referee has come over discussing with the statisticians exactly how that goal should be awarded. Let's see how they do it, Kenny. At any rate, they're ready for the kickoff. Most of the fans have stayed around. Some have left. Sting moving left to right, but only 27 seconds left. Cosmos kickoff, Steve Moyers. He's done a big job tonight. Walks around Glenn. Moyers coming. Shoots. Good save, Ferner. Dieter Ferner. Quick reactions. Up to Pato Marhedic with 15 seconds left on the clock. Tries to go through to Granica. Daryl G. Fighting Hall. Now Boris Bandoff. 8 seconds left. Ryan trying to crowd G. Can't do it. G coming to Moyers. And there's the horn. This soccer game has come to an end. The Cosmos win their home opener over the Sting by a score of 14-10. First time since 1977 the Cosmos have beaten the Sting at anything, but they were tough tonight. Giorgio Canalia, right before your very eyes, has set a brand new North American Soccer League indoor record with 7 goals. The Sting now 1-1 on the season. Their home opener December 18th at the stadium against Montreal. We want to thank the crew out here tonight from CCR, our associate director, Bob Eisenstadt. Our director has been Jay Mullen, the associate producer, Dick Burak. Tonight's telecast was produced by Jack Jacobson. And for Kenny Stern, this is Howard Balsam.